Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Big Pond here at the Illinois Ice Arena. I am Ori Benatar, and I will be joined by Anthony Pasquale soon. And we've got ourselves an Illini hockey game against the Robert Morris Eagles. Going to be a good one here, Anthony. Illinois winning 6-0. One thing technical-wise that we are going to let you guys know, we do have two different YouTube streams going right now. Once again, I'm here for a game, and we couldn't connect video with my computer. So we've actually got the video stream happening on one stream on our YouTube page, the Illini Hockey YouTube page, and this is going to be the radio broadcast. So that way we can get you guys some video and some audio as well. That's kind of the plan that we've got going on right now. Again, sorry for the inconvenience. So you can probably have two things going. If the audio doesn't sync up, potentially likely occurrence. But if you want to hear our call on the game, then we have it right here. So last night, Illinois won 6-0, Anthony, against the Robert Morris Eagles from Illinois. The story when we entered on Friday was basically Illinois has won every game at home. That still stands. Robert Morris, though, they entered Friday having won all their games on the road. That does not stand anymore. They had their first road loss.
Yeah, I mean, the Illini came out yesterday and coming off a weekend where they got swept by Lindenwood, they went from the 2 to the number 1 team in the nation. It was a big momentum boost to kind of come back on our own home ice and get a win, which is something we hadn't seen over the last week. So it was a good game. The Illini jumped on the Eagles and won the game 6-0, so I hope to see more of the same today.
Drew Richter got two. Kasper Ribba scored another. John Moskalok got one. Evan Sabo got a goal. Charlie Sulk had one as well. Bobby Ernsting had four assists, and Jake Barnhart had 23 saves to get the shutout. So if Illinois, for example, you know, they have all their wins at home, they haven't won a game on the road, what's going to be the game plan for moving on as the season goes on? Because after a 6-0 win, you're expecting the Illini to probably get another victory tonight. But why is this team so different between home and road?
Well, I think this team really likes their home ice, which I guess is a good thing considering this weekend and next weekend we're here. So hopefully we can lock up some W's. But I think the big thing is when you're on the road, you're just not as comfortable. It might have to do with the fact that the other rinks aren't the same size, and usually other teams play better in their home rink. But if the Illini want to do something major down the road here and potentially win a championship, winning on the road, especially back-to-back games, is going to be something important coming up.
Looking for the fourth home sweep series. Again, we've got about 5 minutes till puck drop. It's a bit confusing for this broadcast. I know we weren't able to be here yesterday, but we are here today. So there are two separate YouTube streams up right now. We've got the audio stream here, and we've got a separate video stream happening as well. So there might be a little bit of a mix with the ambient noise and stuff, but in order for us to get a broadcast in order for you guys to have a voice during the game, you have this option to have the audio stream and the video stream happening. Again, we're sorry about the technical difficulties here. As Anthony Pasquale and Claire O'Brien are with me today, I am Ori Benatar in what is going to be probably another exciting game of Illini hockey. But a potential absence that you saw, Anthony, Kasper Ribba wasn't dressed.
Yeah, he scored a goal yesterday. He's got 6 goals and 3 assists on the year, 9 points. He's our second or third leading point scorer, I believe. And when we got the lines today, we noticed he wasn't in the lineup. And that's something uncharacteristic. This is his first game not dressing. And we didn't get a chance to talk to Coach Fabrini about it, so we don't know if there's a potential injury, maybe a sickness going on. But for whatever reason, Kasper Ribba's out. And that's going to be a major loss on the first line. That first line is usually Kasper Ribba, Bobby Ernsting, and John Moskalok. And you're losing 9 points off that line when you're starting number 21, Mike Lenzi. He's scored in his games that he's played. He's only played 3 so far this year, but Kasper Ribba out of the lineup is a big loss for the Illini.
Yeah, and taking a look at the rest of the lines for Illinois, you've also got Stephen Quinn, Luke Forfar, Drew Richter. Richter had a great game yesterday, scored 2 goals. He was also key in that win against Central Oklahoma a few weeks back. Obviously, this team is money at home, but they haven't been able to get it together quite yet on the road, losing to Lindenwood back-to-back times last weekend. We got Homerin, Kolas, Reese. Ken Dottie's going to be in the second line of defense, so the Illini lineup is pretty normal as expected, but obviously no Kasper Ribba does not help the cause. Taking a look at just some of the results for the Robert Morris Eagles, similar situation in Illinois. It's actually kind of fascinating that we entered this series Friday with Illinois undefeated at home, winless on the road. Robert Morris, the complete opposite.
Right.
All their wins are on the road. They came in with all their wins coming from their own undefeated, and they haven't won a game at home. They lost to Lindenwood twice, lost the first game 5-1, lost the second game 10-0, lost to Michigan Dearborn twice, and before coming here to Champaign, they lost to Davenport twice in two very close hockey games, losing 6-4 and 6-5. Their wins coming against Rochester on the road and Toledo on the road. This team is 4-7 entering tonight. Illinois is 7-3-2.
Yeah, and I mean, that just goes to show you this team is 4-7. Like you mentioned, they're ranked 12th in the country. That's not something that usually happens where a below 500 team is ranked that highly. But when you see a team like Robert Morris, they're playing against some of the best in the country. They lost 2 to Lindenwood. That's pretty much expected. They're the number one team in the country. And Davenport's no joke as well. And I don't think it matters where you play those games against a team like Lindenwood. Lindenwood's got to win because they're a fast team, they're a big team, and they're a very tough team to beat. So I think that's a little bit of a – that 4-7 record isn't something you should look at and say, oh, this should be an easy win for the Illini, because this team is ranked 12th, and we dropped from 4th to 6th over the last week – or, excuse me, 4th to 10th, 6 spots over the last week. So this is without a doubt a big game for the Illini, and we shouldn't take the Eagles lightly.
Once again, if you're just joining us, we've got two separate YouTube streams going. This is the audio stream. It's titled 11-3-18, Illini Hockey versus Robert Morris. There's another stream, Illini Hockey versus Robert Morris. That has the video. So that's the third time I mentioned it in the beginning of this audio broadcast, because we just want to clarify that that is the... we had some tech difficulties, so you can have video. We've also got the audio of the game right now. But we are going to pause currently as we're ready to hear the introduction of the starting lineups as well as the national anthem.
For tonight's Central States Collegiate Hockey League game between the Robert Morris University Illinois Eagles and your University of Illinois Fighting Illini. Now let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First of all, for Robert Morris, starting in center, a sophomore from Chicago, number 43, Jake. Number 7, Stephen Kirk. this time, ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise and face the flag above the scoreboard and kindly remove all caps and hats for the playing of our national anthem.
All right, we're ready to get this one started here. I'll mention this for the final time. This is the audio stream. There is another stream on YouTube that is video because we cannot get the video working with the Wirecast program. And we're ready to get started here, though. Second game between Illinois and Robert Morris. The Illini won 6-0 yesterday. 7 wins for Illinois. They've all been at the Big Pond. Every team that has come here has not been able to defeat this Illini team as they've begun conference play here. Anthony, overall prediction for this game?
Well, I think the Illini are going to come out on top. I really do. I think Robert Morris is a very good team, but I think the Illini are better, definitely on this home ice. And I'm expecting to see goals from Luke Forfar today, along with one from Stephen Quinn.
Taking a look at the goaltenders in between the pipes in this one, it will be Jake Barnhart once again for Illinois. Had a shutout last night against this Robert Morris team. Illinois, a team that had some trouble getting some shutouts. They've got... They had the shutout against Michigan State early in the season, had another one against Illinois State. So this was their third shutout of the season, which was last night. And then in goal for Robert Morris, it will be Chris Mallon, whose goals against average is above 5, as we are ready for the opening faceoff here at the Big Pond Illinois Ice Arena. The Illini trying to stay undefeated at home. Can Robert Morris split the series here as the Illini win the opening faceoff in center ice, as Kendati and Opilka are out there with Forfar, Quinn, and Richter, and an immediate offside here just 8 seconds in.
And one of the things you see is the Illini came out with their usual second line today, Stephen Quinn, Luke Forfar, and Drew Richter. That's something you don't usually see, but then again, Kasper Ribba's missing from that first line, so that immediately demotes them.
Robert Morris dumping it into the Illini zone. Barnhart coming out of his net, just going to swing it around here towards Candotti, but chasing after it is Martin for Robert Morris. Shot near the point, wide, and it's going to be grabbed by Robert Morris as Joe Malfetta has it now. And now maybe a chance for Illinois, 2-on-1. Quinn to the left of Richter. Richter skating on the right side. Richter trying to get some moves. Very good poke check there from Robert Morris. And that came from Chris Skordilis. And now it's in center ice. Quinn going to pass it back to Kendati.
That was a great defensive play. Potentially saved a goal. A 2-on-1 is never a good way to open up a game, but that was a big save by Skordilis.
Bobby Ernsting on the ice now, the captain who had 4 assists last night in the 6-0 win against this Eagles team. Near the net, grabbed finally by Robert Morris, trying to get some momentum there, but that's a good pickoff from the Illini coming from Michael Lenzi, making just his 4th appearance this season. Here is Lenzi, pass towards Ernsting, trying to cross ice to Joe Nolan, and that's going to be grabbed by Jack Graham. Nolan and Graham passing it between each other. Wrist shot from Graham is wide, hits off the back of the ice, but it will fly all the way back out towards Nolan. Now shot towards the net, and it's going to be an easy grab there from Chris Mallon, stopping the clock at 18:38.
I mean, you mentioned Mike Lenzi. We said before he's filling in for Kasper Ribba today. He's making some noise on his first shift of the game. That's something you like to see. He's trying to make a name for himself and fill in the shoes of Kasper, or the skates, I should say, of Kasper Ribba, which is not an easy task.
I'd love to see one hockey game in shoes. That would be quite a blast. As Charlie Salk now with a wrist shot just goes wide. He scored last night too. There's a pass near the point, looking for a conversion there, but not going to happen as Paul Prikos is going to chase after it with Salk next to him. And it's going to be an icing call there as Hart of Robert Morris went after it. So far, no team has been able to get momentum on the ice, but Illinois has had the better end of the game in the first minute and a half.
Yeah, they've been controlling the puck in their zone, which is always good to see. You just want to see a little bit more shots on net, so we'll see if this series will bring something different.
Face-off won by the Eagles, and moving it into the center of the ice now. This is a good chance there as it's going to go out. Nick Rizzo skating all the way from his own end to the other end of the ice, but it goes out of play, and both teams will make a line change here. Again, Robert Morris coming into this game, Billy Carr's team, 4-7. They had their first road loss last night. They've won all four of their games on the road. They haven't won at home this season, as we got a faceoff here between Mike Cacciato and number 14, Neil Novosel of Illinois. This is the second conference series for Illinois. They were in Lindenwood last weekend. Anthony, you were there. That must have been a fun drive down to St. Louis.
Yeah, it was quick, but the Illini couldn't get much going against Lindenwood, so it wasn't as good as it could have been.
Yeah, Lindenwood has beaten both of these teams pretty handily as Neil Novosel gets hit and loses a glove. Playing with one glove now. Turner now trying to get around Kendati. Good defending there from the starting Illini defenseman as Kendati moving down that left side of the ice. The glove is still near the left side. Turner finally hits it out. Now gets a pass from his teammate, and it's a odd man rush here for Robert Morris. Turner shot from the left circle, and an easy glove save for Barnhart as Opilka throw in a bit of a push there towards Dylan Holt. Two defensemen going at it early, 17:36 left.
See, there's one thing you might have missed if you're just listening to this audio. After he lost his glove there, he was our defenseman. He was in the zone, so we needed somebody to fall back. Luke Forfar, veteran in his, I believe, third year with the Illini, stepped back and made that odd man rush a little bit easier for the Illini.
We do have the video stream, so you can definitely see how that glove came off and everything. As Illinois win the faceoff in the defensive zone, Nolan is saucering it up to Richter. Tried to get a touch on it, but it is going to be an easy icing call for the officials. 17:27 ago, we're 10 minutes time-wise into this game. 3 minutes. Well, I think what I just said didn't make sense because it's a 7 o'clock start. It's 7:11 right now. All my times are messed up, man. As it's going to be a face-off in the Illini defensive zone. Forfar and Martin will take the face-off. And it will be won by Robert Morris, but quickly taken by the Illini as Nolan's going to pass it around the board to Jack Graham. Graham's going to get hit by Malfetta. Robert Morris looking to grab the puck, scored Dallas chasing after it. Stephen Quinn going 4-2, but another icing call. A lot of clock stoppages early here. We haven't even gotten through 3 minutes of this game. Just a lot of icing calls, no really amazing chances so far. Robert Morris defensively have been pretty sound.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I think the Illini have been pretty sound on defense as well, which was expected. But the more this game goes on, the less stoppages I think will benefit the Illini in this big rink.
Cross ice pass there from Graham to Luke Forfar. Another icing call, so three consecutive icings for Illinois. Only took about 15, 20 seconds off the game clock, and it's going to be another faceoff in the Illini defensive zone as Graham, Nolan, Forfar, Richter, and Quinn are out there. It is that starting forward line with, I believe, the second, third defensive pairing. Nolan and Graham listed as the first defensive pairing, but they weren't out there for the opening faceoff as a wrist shot is blocked. That came from Nick Rizzo of Robert Morris. Cross-ice pass to his teammate. Kreides looking for a deflection there, as in front of the net was Hart, couldn't get it in the net. As Robert Morris looking for a nice spell of possession here in the offensive zone. Now a bit of a tussle between, looks like Mancini and Graham. Finally won by Graham. Now Forfar passing it to Quinn. Quinn moving his body around. Puck is going to float its way to the left board. Now popping up in our peripheral vision. As both teams unable to grab some possession in neutral zone ice so far. It's been a fight between sticks right now, but finally Illinois able to corral it as Moskaluk is on the ice, passing it to Charlie Sulk. Two of the five goal scorers from the game yesterday, Drew Richter having two. Ribba scored as well. Evan Sabo got a goal too. And another high-scoring home victory for Illinois last night. Jake Barnhart grabs the puck, and there's a bit of miscommunication. Skating in there was Mike Cacciato grabbing it, but was unable to get a shot on Barnhart. Robert Morris looking to build. Turner passes it to Stover. Stover wrist shot. Now a nice easy pass. Turner with an open ice shot. Good save by Barnhart with the pad and the stick as Dahlberg is just going to fling it off the board and giving it to Stover, who does the same. But Joe Nolan finally gets the puck.
Yeah, it was a great save by Barnhart. He looks good today, but I think All of his saves have been just a product of sloppy passing from the Illini. The Illini have had three or four icing calls already, also because of their sloppy passing. I think they got to get that passing from stick to stick if they want this game to go a little bit differently.
To the board to Salk. Salk going to pass it to Paul Precos as Robert Morris make a line change. Justin Reese in the middle of the ice just hits it off and cleared out by Dom Manocchio of Robert Morris as Precos has it now. Might lose possession. He gets hit on the boards by Scott Koash. A lot of tussles on the board so far in the beginning of this game as we're 5 minutes into the first period. Still no score between Illinois and Robert Morris. Neither team has had really good concrete chances so far. But here comes Thomas Kolas, a shot looking for the top corner, but an easy grab for Chris Mallon.
Yeah, Kolas is one of the best wristers on the team. That was a product of it there. Good save there by Christopher Mallon, but I think that was good that the Illini got a shot off. It had been a little bit. The Eagles were controlling the puck in their offensive zone for a while. So a faceoff in our offensive zone should look pretty good for the Illini right about now.
Faceoff win for Homerin of Illinois, who's on the ice right now. Chance Homerin, but now Illinois re-getting it with Opilka. Here's Reese in neutral zone. Getting hit on the boards. A little bit of confusion there between the Robert Morris players trying to move the puck around. Casey Labonte has it, and he's going to cross ice pass it there to, looks like, Scott Koash. Wrist shot from very wide distance. That was actually from Dom Manocchio. And now Illinois trying to get a rush going, but the puck is going to go all the way down to Robert Morris's zone. No icing call. And now they're going to try and set up a play. Here's Illinois make another line change in the neutral zone now. Here's Opilka, who has it in the defensive zone. Cross-ice pass to Kandati. And Illinois trying to get something set up here. Sabo open in the offensive zone there. But so far, the stick handling has just not been there for either team. The puck has just been flopping around the ice so far as Robert Morris trying to move it down now. There's some good puck control. Two defenders fall down. Martin skating down the ice, looking for a cross-ice pass. Good poke check there from Jake Barnhart to get it out. And now Illinois trying to get a rush going. Novacell with the defender coming right in behind him. A little bit of an interruption, and there's a big hit there. A couple of players falling down on the ice. One of them was Rich Hatton. Now Robert Morris trying to get it out of their own zone. Some decent stick control here from the Eagles. They're trying to get their fifth away win of the year. Quinn passing it now to Forfar. Forfar trying to get around the defending, but good poke checking once again from Robert Morris.
There's just been a lot of loose pucks, like you said, and I think controlling those pucks and making sure that the Illini have crisp passes are going to be key if they want to get some scoring opportunities, because they've been lacking so far.
7 minutes into the first period, still no score here. Again, this is our audio stream. We got a video stream going on as well on YouTube. It is a little bit of Illini hockey inception right now as Joe Nolan is going to get checked into the boards by Koash. And Robert Morris now with puck possession in the offensive zone. Drew Richter chasing after it with Holt just in behind him. Stephen Quinn going to skate it around, but now Robert Morris moving it down the ice. Stover on the near the right circle. Pass it around the boards. Good puck movement there. Barnhart just comes off of his crease and makes the save. One-on-one now. Stephen Quinn. Couple defenders behind him. Stephen Quinn shot! And it goes over the pipe. But Quinn's able to rebound it. Back to Ernsting. And it's going to go back to the Robert Morris defensive zone.
That was a great save by Barnhart. He came out and sacrificed his body for that puck there. A great save by him, and we've seen a lot of it so far. And he's kind of emerging himself as the top goalie for the Illini. He's gotten two starts in a row, and that's something we haven't seen early on this season.
Passing it around the defensive zone now is the Illinois Fighting Illini as Charlie Salk with a backhand pass to Ribba, who's actually on, well, it's not Ribba, it's Lindsay wearing Ribba's jersey. It's going to be a stoppage of play here. We're going to have a faceoff coming up with 11:43 to go.
Yeah, Casper Ribba's actually number 18, but for some reason, Michael Lindsay, number 21, is wearing the jersey with Ribba's name on the back.
That's fun. That makes our job easier,
yeah,
for sure.
It'll be Bobby Ernsting taking the faceoff. He's been really good this year on the faceoff.
Yeah, money on faceoff as he wins another one in the defensive zone. Opilka now poking it around with Cacciotto of Robert Morris, now looking for a pass center ice. Robert Morris utilizing a lot of those passes from behind the net for a center pass. Good poke there. Looked like it came from Lenzi. Skating down the ice, could not get a breakaway.
He's making a name for himself, even though his jersey doesn't say so.
Far shot there. Good stick save from Malin as we've got 11:14 to go in this first period. Opilka just ahead of the blue line, keeping it onside. Wrist shot coming in, looking for a deflection from Ernsting, but doesn't get it. Now a nice pass, breakaway chance, but it won't be. And offside there is Tony Dahlberg.
Yeah, the Illini had two defensemen controlling the point there on that offensive break, and that's usually something that the Illini feed off of. That was something they couldn't get developed in Lindenwood last weekend, but it's something that they seem to be trying to develop early and trying to make that a key point of their strategy. But on that particular play, it backfired a little bit as they had a breakaway opportunity. Thankfully, it was an offside.
Illini faceoff win. We got 11 minutes left in the first period. Still no score in this one. Illini did get off to a slow start in yesterday's game as well, but then they came alive early in the third period, scoring three of their six goals. Molfetta's shot off of the stick of Candotti into the netting out of play with 10:50 to go. As it is a pretty packed house here in the Big Pond, it is Dad's weekend, and of course a lot of Illini fans very excited for this good weekend of Illini athletics. Basketball had their exhibition yesterday and won. Football, massive win against Minnesota on Dad's Day, scoring over 50 points. Now they're hoping to see an Illini hockey sweep. A nice good crowd here as all the dads and moms celebrating the parents' weekend here.
Yeah, it'd be nice to see the trifecta of Illini sports with the basketball team, the football team, and hopefully two hockey victories. That'll be something great to see for the parents.
And two more volleyball victories. They got a win against Ohio State yesterday as Illini Athletics having a very good way and weekend to start November as the puck is now in the Illini offensive zone. They're fighting around for it, and Chance Homerin is going to check a man into the boards, but Robert Morris trying to move it down ice.
So far, it's a no-loss November.
No-loss November. Good pass to Rizzo. Shot. Oh, what a save by Jake Barnhart as he just flew around his net and made an incredible acrobatic save. Oh, my God.
Barnhart's looking really good tonight.
He just did like a 360 on his butt on the ice. Just turned around and made an insane save. Check out the video stream to see that one. Joe Nolan pass to Hatton. Puck lost there, as that was the highlight of this first period. Shot from distance, and Barnhart makes a little bit of a more standard save as he just cups the puck into his midsection. God, that was an amazing save.
Yeah, that one looked a little bit easier than that acrobatic one, but he was ranging to the left, and he realized the puck wasn't as far back as he thought, so he kind of fell back, flung his glove up, and he ended up knocking it with his pad. Great save by Barnhart. Hopefully that's a little bit momentum boost that the Illini need.
Barnhart just makes another save. Robert Morris guy winning the faceoff, immediately shooting it, and then just, grab it with my glove, no problem. So it's a Jake Barnhart exhibition over the last minute and a half here. 9:40 to go in the first period. As Robert Morris have it in central ice, is Lucas Stover looking for, but now Illinois looking for an attack here. Hatton shot from distance, hits off of the stick of Malin. He's just going to grab it and freeze the puck with 9:33 to go.
Yeah, you love to see great saves like Barnhart's been doing, but I think anybody on the Illini side would prefer that they have their puck in the offensive zone. Barnhart's keeping this team in it, but they got to get some offensive chances, and hopefully it'll start with this Quinn Forfar Richter line that put up two goals yesterday, and they've been scoring all year.
A weird faceoff win from Illinois. The puck kind of was bouncing around like a bouncy ball, but now it finally settles. And Candotti's going to chase after it. It's Hart in behind him. Josh Hart, not the one on the Lakers. Oh, big hit there from Forfar, as flopping down on the ice there was Sam Mancini. As Quinn now gets past the blue line, has Forfar to his left. Forfar had a backhand shot and crossed the net, but no final touch from an Illini player. Forfar has it behind the net. Now passing it to Quinn, back to Forfar, passing it to the point to Tyler Opilka. Wrist shot from Opilka, looking for a deflection. Good save there from Malin, but it's recollected by Illinois with less than 9 minutes to go in the first. Opilka cross ice to Candotti. Candotti looking for a shot in the lower corner, but the puck is now reopened for Illinois as they've got a good spell here of some shots. Candotti slap shot. Quinn can't get a touch on it as it was wide. 8:39 left in the first period. Opilka losing the puck, cleared by Robert Morris, and now they're trying to get a rush going. It is a one-on-two. Opilka defending well, winning the puck back immediately for Illinois in the middle of a Robert Morris line change. Opilka trying to get around his defender. His backhanded shot saved by Malin, trying to get a wrap around, but good defending once again from the Eagles, and now they finally get the puck once again and get it to the neutral zone, only to the stick of John Moskaluk.
The 4-4 Quinn Richter line's looking really good. They're controlling the puck better than any other line, so I'd expect to see that line emerge as the one that's going to score a goal here first, at least tonight.
8:04 left, icing call on Illinois. Still no score in this game. We're starting to see better stick handling for sure. It was a little bit rough for the first 5 or 6 minutes, both teams unable to get a good handle on the puck. But I think we're seeing both teams create some chances. For Illinois, you see right now, a lot of chances from the point, looking for those deflections in front of net. And most of Robert Morris' chances have been looking for passes in front of net into the slot for those shots as Illinois dumps it into the offensive zone. Touched by Ernsting, grabbed by Lenzi. With less than 8 minutes now, Moskaluk moving it around. That was an interesting pass there to Lenzi. As Ernsting tries to get it, Cacciotto is able to clear it out, but only to the stick of Jack Graham, as Illinois has been able to keep the puck in the offensive zone for the last 2 minutes or so. Now behind the net is Ernsting, looking for Nolan. Pass not strong enough for him. Nolan against Turner, but it finally gets batted around to Nick Rizzo.
The Illini, like you mentioned, I think this has just been, unfortunately, too much of the case this year when they start a little bit sloppy in the first period. I mean, they've won all 7 games here at the Big Pond, but I think they'd like to have a better start in most of those 7 games.
Maybe getting a late first period goal could help them out, just like it did yesterday, as Illinois is trying to get their 8th win at the Big Pond and their 4th sweep of the season. They swept Michigan State early this year. They swept Illinois State at home. They swept Central Oklahoma, and now they're trying to sweep the Robert Morris Eagles as the puck is paused near the left board in the Illini offensive zone with 6:58 left, and we're going to have a faceoff near mid-ice.
I think one of the things we've noticed with the Illini so far is they've been getting hit and hitting a lot. In the beginning few games, the Illini were the supreme force of physicality, but in their more recent games, especially against Lindenwood, Central Oklahoma, and Robert Morris tonight, they've been getting hit a lot more than they're used to, but I think they've adjusted their game plan well.
Puck in the neutral zone now. Illinois trying to get it. Kolas losing it, though, and it's grabbed by Ryan Martin, the forward for Robert Morris.
You mentioned Ryan Martin. He is their leading point scorer. He's got 15 so far this year for the Eagles. 6 goals, 9 assists from Rochester, Minnesota. He's been a great addition to this team.
Yeah, 15 points. Pretty good for an 11-game span so far.
Yeah, that outscores any player on our team by 5, I believe, with Moskaluk and Stephen Quinn leading the way with 10 points.
Now a chance for Illinois. Shot from the wrist across ice. No good there as Chance Homerin was looking for the goal. It was a 2-on-1 chance for Illinois as Paul Prikos passed it middle of the ice. Grabbed by Robert Morris forward. But now bouncing around there. Robert Morris trying to get it past that blue line. They do. Martin has it, but now Illinois looking for the rush. Reese is going to pass it to Hatton, but it's going to be grabbed and dumped by Chris Skordilis.
I've noticed early in this game, the Illini have had 3 or 4 occasions where they've had 2 players run into each other and end up losing a chance or potentially putting their team defensively at a lull there. That's not
Save
something you like to see.
Oh, almost a goal there for Illinois. Now again, middle of the ice. Good chance for Illinois as Kolas goes up. It hits off of the shoulder of Barnhart, and then he grabs it, tries to freeze the puck. He doesn't. Finally batted towards that right-sided board. Player shaken up there as down is Josh Hart of Robert Morris with 5:24 left in the first period. He got hit hard into the boards.
Yeah, he got hit hard into the boards by his own player. And another player jumped on top of that. There's a pileup of 3 Eagles, and that couldn't have been good on his back and head area. He still looks slow to skate off, and he hasn't lifted his head yet, so that can't be good for Josh Hart.
Face-off now in the neutral zone with 5:24 to go.
It'll be Mr. Faceoff, Luke Forfar. He's been really good this year.
I mean, Illinois in general, Ernsting, Forfar, they've just been so good on the faceoff every time they play here. Even when they play on the road, just a team that does so well when it comes to the faceoffs.
Which is key in controlling the puck, which is Coach Fabrini's kind of motto there, take the puck, right. Control the puck.
But of course, a commentator's curse, as Robert Morris won that faceoff and almost got an easy deflected goal there. But just falled in front of Barnhart, who was able to poke it out. But now Robert Morris moving it around. It's dumped. Nolan going after it. Graham in front of him. He's got Dahlberg and Turner either side of him trying to get it from him. And now Illinois trying to get it out of that defensive zone. Cacciotto able to get it for the Eagles, trying to pass middle to Dahlberg. Good steal there from Joe Nolan. Now potential breakaway here for Stephen Quinn. Passing in the middle. Richter wasn't there in time to get the open net goal, looking for his third in two. Now a rush from Robert Morris. Shot, different distance. Good save from Barnhart with the stick. Now trying to get in front of net to Turner. Dahlberg had the shot there. Now Illinois coming back up ice. Richter on the right side. Forfar and Quinn in the middle. That first forward line for Illinois up. Forfar now gets hit into the board with Quinn now on that right circle. Point passing for Illinois as they're just controlling possession here with 4:20 to go in the first. Ken Dottie, left circle now, moving around, looking to pass it in front of net. No one, Moskala going into the slot, can't get the pass to him. And Ken Dottie is going to get it to Moskala there near the board. And there's a shot from the point. Stephen Quinn was in front there. Great pass from Moskala, but a good save by Malin. That was probably the Illini's best and clearest chance of the first period.
Yeah, going back to that breakaway, I think I would have liked to see Stephen Quinn shoot that puck. He had a good shot, high percentage opportunity. Might have been able to sneak over the shoulder, the glove of Malin there. I think I would have liked to see Quinn shoot it. Never know how it would have worked out, but still a good offensive chance for the Illini.
Faceoff win for Ken Dottie. Ernsting deflected it, but it hit off his stick and just went into the boards. But Illinois still have the puck here in search of that first goal of the game. They scored six yesterday. Moskaluk's shot, it's off. Ernsting now looking for a good recovery and save there from Chris Malin, who just skated towards his right post and saved a potential Bobby Ernsting goal. 3:39 to go now in the first. Yeah, there's just a little bit
of tie up over there.
Yeah, a little bit of a tie up. I mean, this is our blind spot. It pretty much just looked like two guys watching just the puck just standing there.
It's but a now, fun sport to watch.
Right, and now Illinois finally gets it. Opilka trying to pass it. It hits off a Robert Morris stick, but now collected by Illinois. Ken Dottie's got it now. Left side looking for a deflection, and it goes right into the midsection of Chris Malin. 3:13 left, still 0-0.
17 minutes of this game, we've seen no goals and no penalties. And now that I said that, there should be about two more goals and two penalties in these last 3 minutes.
Well, let's be generous here. Probably 5-5.
Yeah.
Surprisingly, I mean, the last time we were here for a home game, it was in the Big Pond, a lot of penalties. Jack Graham looking for a shot now from the point. Another save from Chris Malin as Illinois has been able to get successive shots over the past 3 minutes here. But Malin is making a lot of saves. Barnhart is too, so I'd say the goaltenders are playing really well. It's the latter half of this first period. There's just been a lot of good chances.
Yeah, there's not as many stoppages as we saw early and not as much sloppy play, just really good goaltending, which makes for a good hockey game.
And no penalties, of course, as you mentioned. 3 minutes left in the first period now. Illinois has the puck. Reese looking for a deflection. Homerin was in front of net. Tried to go through his legs, but he's unable to get it. Eagles still trying to get it out of their defensive zone. They haven't been able to for the last 2.5 minutes, and now they finally do. And now skating up ice in the neutral zone. Good pass from Nietzsche. There's a shot, and it's off the shoulder of Barnhart as Ryan Martin was looking for the wrist shot. So Barnhart and Malin, I would say, on my guesstimation, have probably made each 10, 12 saves.
Yeah, definitely. And I think there's been a lot of high percentage chances in these last 10 minutes for both teams, but the goalies have just kind of snuffed away. But you mentioned a couple minutes ago no penalties for the Illini so far, but that's been something the Illini has kind of circled as one of their faults, I guess you could say. They're a highly penalized team, so that's definitely good for Fabrini's crew to not have been penalized so far.
Giveaway from Illinois, pass into the slot, can't be settled by Turner. It goes all the way back to Skordilis. Quinn's chasing after it, trying to get it. Skordilis skating though, clearing it out. And now Robert Morris trying to move up ice. Turner was past the blue line, but it is going to be called for an icing.
Stephen Quinn had a breakaway chance earlier in this game, and he probably missed out on two more just because the puck's been on the wrong side
of his
body.
He's had a couple of those, though. He's had like three times where he's been pretty open in that offensive zone ice, having a chance to get a shot off.
And just losing it on the backside there. That's something that the Illini clean up. This could be a 1 or 2 nothing game with the way Stephen Quinn handles the puck.
And even with the phenomenal saves we've seen from Jake Barnhart, I mean, the goaltenders are keeping this a 0-0 game. I think we've just made that discovery as we were talking through it, as Robert Morris moved through that neutral zone. Cacciotto trying to get by Ken Dottie. Can't get a pass off, kind of whiffs on it. And now it's finally grabbed by Ken Dottie, who's going to pass it to Stephen Quinn. He gives it to Richter now. He's getting past the blue line. Richter's shot hits off of the knee of Nick Rizzo. Still with Illinois. A couple of big hits there from Robert Morris. Grabbed by Opilka with the hand. He's going to pass it to Richter. Richter skating it around. Pass there. Slap shot from Novacell blocked. Quinn re-gets it. Now Opilka Once again, Kendati and Opilka passing it between each other at the point. Now shot there. Good save by Malin as Kendati passed it into the slot, and Malin had to extend that left leg and making that pad save. 1:43 left as we got a bit of chirping between Stephen Quinn and a Robert Morris player.
When anybody thinks of a defenseman, you think of obviously somebody who plays defense, and they stand at the point and whack the puck, and they think that's it. But one of the biggest keys to being a defenseman is being able to keep the puck in your zone when they try to clear. Opilka had a great keep there, and that led to the Illini getting two or three more shots on goal. Great job by Opilka there.
Got about 90 seconds left in this first period. Illinois and Robert Morris tussled up in that right corner of the ice in the Illini offensive zone, but Robert Morris finally freeing the puck, dumping it down, and it's finally grabbed by a Robert Morris stick. It's Josh Hart. Hart can't get it. Good defending there from Illinois as Novosel's going to try and get it towards Evan Sabo. Finally dumped off into the defensive zone as Opilka's going after it along with Josh Hart. Hart wins the race, gets the puck, but Opilka's going to get it as it hits off of the stick of Hart. And now Opilka trying to skate around him, but it fumbles a little bit there. Two-on-one chance. Wrist shot. Good save by Jake Barnhart. What a shot there. Looked like it was from Josh Hart. And a quick, fast glove from Jake Barnhart with 56.5 to go.
Yeah, Barnhart's got a hot glove. He's got a hot pad. And, I mean, he's got a hot right and left blocker as well. He's been everywhere on this ice. He's owning every inch in between those pipes and making it really hard for the Eagles to get anything going.
Giving a show here to this Big Pond Illinois Ice Arena crowd here on Dad's Weekend as Robert Morris having once again passing the right circle. There's a shot. Oh, it hits off of, I think, the mask. It was like the shoulder mask of
it got
Barnhart.
Up on Barnhart there.
Barnhart is probably approaching 20 saves already in this first period as we've got 40 seconds left in the first as both goaltenders have been tremendous thus far as Graham is going to dump it towards the neutral zone. Holt is able to get it as we got 30 seconds left in the first period. Still no score. There's the pass from Michael Lindsay giving it to Joe Nolan. Nolan trying to skate around his defenseman. There's a nice quick shot from Moskaluk and another save from Malin with 19 flat on the clock. Moskaluk, good pass into the slot there. But Illinois is kind of taking a page out of the Robert Morris book. We saw a lot of those passes into the slot from behind the net from Robert Morris. Now we're seeing that from Illinois more than those point shots.
Yeah, and I think Moskaluk has been key in it. He delivered one of those passes from behind, and he received it there and put a good shot on net. Moskaluk's been a good offensive player for the Illini. I wouldn't be surprised if he netted one too.
Just 12 seconds left in this first period. Robert Morris have the puck now. Now to Illinois. Moskaluk's getting past the blue line with 6 seconds left. Maybe looking for one last shot. Moskaluk's going to shoot it. It's off the stick of Malin. Now trying to wrap it around. And that's how the period is going to end. So zeros on the clock. Zeros for both teams. Zero penalties as well. A quick first period in retrospect. Both teams had some really good chances, but the story of this period has got to be Malin and Barnhart, both making some great saves.
Yeah, you said zeros everywhere. Zeros on the scoreboard, zeros on the score sheet. The only place on the box score where you're not going to see zeros is next to the goalies' names with saves. A lot of great saves. Barnhart made two phenomenal ones along with a bunch of other saves that cannot be declared any less good. And then Malin's also been really good, not allowing the Illini to score any goals. Fun first period, should be a good second one.
Yeah, Malin with just some good awareness and Barnhart with the acrobatic, flashy, quick reflex saves. So we are through one here at the Big Pond. We're going to take a quick break and take it to the intermission report with Anthony and Claire. Once again, this is the audio stream. We do have video on a separate stream. We'll be back in a bit. We'll be right back.
And so, Anthony, what have you seen from the Illini this first half?
Yeah, the Illini have played a very strong first period, I think, in my opinion. They started off a little bit sloppy, had trouble locating some loose pucks and had some sloppy passes. But aside from that, they've generated some good offensive chances. The defense has been outstanding, not to mention the phenomenal goaltending by Jake Barnhart. He's putting on a clinic in between the pipes. That's always good to see.
Yeah, and Barnhart, this is the second time this season where he's had back-to-back, starts this weekend. Why do you think that's the part of the strategy for this particular series?
Yeah, so we always discuss this in the intermission report. Coach Fabrini had a big tendency early on in the season to go Barnhart for the first period, Allred for the back two, and then in the second game of the series, start Donovan Bird. And they're kind of just getting their goalies reps, but recently you've seen a lot more of Jake Barnhart, and this period was a good testament as to why. And I think solidifying that goaltender is really good for team chemistry defensively, because with a different goaltender, you probably have to play a little bit different defense. So when you have Jake Barnhart in there, especially playing as well as he is, it's good for everybody on the team, especially Jake Barnhart himself, and the defense benefits a lot from it. And when you get a goalie that can generate momentum the way Barnhart did in that first period, that benefits everybody, including the offense. So solidifying that starter and having that starter play well, nothing can be better for a hockey team.
Yeah, and then Barnhart, he had a shutout last night. Do you think the Illini are taking that momentum and running with it today, or skating with it more accurately?
Well, I just want to touch on the fact that we came out yesterday after getting punched in the mouth last weekend, and we won the game 6-0. A shutout by Barnhart, goals from everywhere. I think that's the big thing in terms of momentum. We lost a lot of momentum a week ago. We got swept by Lindenwood. We dropped from the fourth team in the nation to the 10th. Kind of getting right back on track is a huge deal for this hockey team, and solidifying that with a 6-0 victory yesterday, a shutout's always good momentum. And I don't think today we're carrying that momentum as much as we're building on it going forward.
Yeah, and just kind of a tidbit about Lindenwood, where things are there. Lindenwood is number one in the conference, and both Robert Morris and Illinois really need wins this weekend to play catch up, if you will. Do you think that's somehow playing a factor in the Illini's play tonight?
Yeah, I mean, whenever you get swept by a team that's supposedly better than you, you got more work to do, at least more work than you thought you did. And Lindenwood is no joke. They were ranked second a week ago. They swept the number four team in the nation. I think that's enough to get into the first spot. So they're no joke. They're going to be around. We play them again in late January, so that'll be a game to circle on your calendars, ladies and gentlemen. But I think for the Illini, it's just as much for the Robert Morris Eagles as trying to string some wins together, get some points in the conference, just improve their standing going in the playoffs, because the more and more you improve your standing, more and more wins you should get in the playoffs. That's the way it's supposed to be, at least.
Yeah, and another thing about the Illini, like a quick tidbit here, the Illini have all had their wins this season at home. Do you think that there's like a comfort factor there that's really propelling them at home?
I think that's part of it. I think definitely they're comfortable at home. They also, they're a skating team. They're not as much a physical team as they are a skating team. And this rink gives them extra space to do that. For those of you that don't know, we call it the Big Pond because it's bigger. The skating area, the ice, is actually bigger than most CSCHL ice rinks. So that's always good for the Illini. They're a skating team. For a team that is able to use the ice to their advantage, that's something really good to see. And I think that's at least one of the reasons why the Illini excel so much at the Big Pond. But you also have to make a testament to this crowd. Crowds come out week after week, especially this week, Dad's Weekend. We've got a packed house here at the Big Pond. That's always good to see, and I think that kind of feeds into the way that the Illini play at home.
Well, that'll do it for this intermission report. I'm Claire O'Brien alongside Anthony Pasquale, and we will hand it over to Ori and Anthony for the second period.
And welcome to the Big Pond here in Champaign, Illinois. We're getting ready for the second period between Illinois and Robert Morris, Ori, and Anthony back for you as we are ready to get period number two underway. No score in this one, but it's still been a fun game so far for the first 20 minutes. I mean, my goodness, both goaltenders were awesome in that first period.
Yeah, when you put two goaltenders back there making saves the way Barnhart and Malin have been, you're still going to have way for an entertaining period, but might I say that this crowd is ready for a goal, and I think when we get one, they're going to explode.
Oh, definitely. It's a packed house here at the Illinois Ice Arena. Of course, it is Dad's weekend here in Champaign. In the beginning of November, obviously a busy weekend in Illini sports, basketball exhibition, football played their home game, winning against Minnesota. Next weekend, volleyball is going to play Penn State. Just a lot of Illini sports action before we get to the Thanksgiving break that's coming up in just a few weeks as us students are entering our 11th straight week of classes. No breaks in between because it's not a spring semester. There's no halfway point. And yeah, I'm just rambling about this because as a student, you just got a lot of other stuff going on.
Yeah, I mean, as a student, you got so much going on, especially when you're involved in broadcasts and student use.
And hockey.
Yeah.
I mean, these guys practice every day and they still, you know, got to go home, do their homework, all kind of stuff. It's the classic student athlete spiel that I'm giving here. But we got about a minute left until the second period is going to get underway. What do you think either team needs to do just in terms of their offensive momentum to maybe try and break this game open?
Well, especially for the Illini, I like that last five or so minutes. I like the way they generated scoring chances. I think it's just going to be finding that extra pass, not being so deliberate about, oh, I got to make another pass, but just looking for that one extra pass maybe that could get Malin moving left to right laterally, open up spots in the net and see if maybe we could put one in the back of it.
And we have seen the Illini play at home and not score in a first period, but Illinois played seven home games so far. They've won all of them, but also they've scored in all of them, and they've scored a considerable amount of goals. The least amount of goals they've scored in a home game is three, which wasn't even technically three. It was two because it was a shootout win over Central Oklahoma. They got those two goals in a 70-second span. Steven and I were here for that. That was quite the game. But other than that, I mean, they scored 20 against Michigan State, eight against Illinois State. They got technically six, probably counts as seven, against Central Oklahoma. They had the six last night, but this team is just known to have those slow first period starts. But now we got 40 more minutes of hockey left. The second period is going to get started, and we could just see everything open up as the crowd cheers for the Fighting Illini as they come out on the ice, as the goaltenders Barnhart and Malin are looking to continue their hot game so far.
Yeah, you said that the Illini are a team that's kind of known to be a first period kind of start slow, don't really score. That's kind of a mantra that I think the Illini want to escape from. That's not something you want to be known for. You don't want to be known as the team that can't start a game. So I think going forward, especially in such a hard conference season when the Illini are trying to make a name for themselves and make some noise in the playoffs, they got to score early and quick.
Right, but Illinois has so many other reputations that are so good for them. Reigning runners-up in the ACHA, of course, making the national championship last year. They're incredible on the face-off, and guess what? When they are here, they defend their home ice better than most other teams in the ACHA. They are definitely one of the best teams in club Division I hockey that play on their home ice. As the second period has begun, and immediately the faceoff won by Illinois going straight to Jake Barnhart, as the clean sheet of ice that has just been zammed is now being skated on and dirtied on, as Robert Morris now one on two, Martin moving up, getting some support from some of his teammates, Minocchio with his long flowing hair passing it, but it's intercepted by Illinois and frozen by Barnhart 20 seconds into the second.
You mentioned the flowing hair. I think they have two or three players like that.
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, that's just something you don't see a lot with hockey. You see it a little bit more with football. Mm-hmm. But, God, when we see a hockey player just have that helmet on and just got this long hair, I mean, this is like Troy Polamalu-esque hair.
Yeah.
We're seeing from Dom Minocchio. And I think backup goalie Daryl Smith also, one of the guys sporting some long locks for the Eagles as Minocchio has the puck. Nice shot just past the far post, but it's grabbed at the point by Skordilis, trying to pass it to Jack Nitschke, who still has it, trying to pass it around. Nice misdirection on Luke Forfar defending him. Now Nolan getting a hit on the boards. He does get him.
Forfar is one of our best defending forwards. He's been really good all year, and I think he's going to keep that up.
Kicked out by Nolan away from Barnhart, as Illinois trying to get some offense going here as Richter and Quinn are together. grabbed there by Nitschke as Martin is in front of him, passing it around the boards, almost towards the crowd and towards us, but it's a stoppage of play. 1 minute has expired in the second period. Still no score in this one. Again, this is our audio YouTube stream. We've got a second YouTube stream with the video. Try and sync it up as much as you can, but you can't watch the video. It is just not all in one broadcast. As we're going to have a face-off in the Illini offensive zone, as it'll be Chance Homerin losing the face-off to Scott Koash.
The Illini have been really good going this way at the Big Pond this year. Hopefully more of the same comes.
Cross-ice pass grabbed by Josh Hart, trying to get by Charlie Salt. Good pass inside. Koash was trying to get a shot on Barnhart, but it was deflected as he was shooting. And now Illinois with a 3-on-3 chance. Moving it is Thomas Kolaz, trying to middle it. Still alive in the crease, but finally frozen by Malin with 18:32 to go. That'll be another offensive zone faceoff in the Illini's offensive zone.
It's good to see Josh Hart back out there. We saw him get hurt late in the first period, skated off a little bit gingerly. Good to see him out there for the Robert Morris Eagles in this second period.
Homerin again with a face-off, loses it.
He's got such a baseball player's name.
Mike Cacciotto, yeah, he definitely does. Chance Homerin with that. Homerin, his name, trying to get some homers in this one. I don't know how you get a homer in hockey as we have a stoppage of play. 18:22 to go.
Four goals, maybe?
Yeah, I mean, that's probably the closest you get, or you get four goals from each circle.
Oh, yeah.
That's probably the best thing. And then if you want, like, a grand slam, you get one from mid-ice as they're just making up hockey terms here at the Big Pond. It's what we do here in the Illini hockey broadcast team. As Illinois wins a faceoff in the defensive zone, Robert Morris able to keep it onside, pass towards the net to Dahlberg. As the Eagles are trying to keep some possession here, Homerin's going to chase after it, but Opilka behind the net, moving it away from Cacciotto. And finally hit out, but dumped off right behind the net there. Dahlberg, and there's a shot from an odd angle there, an acute angle from Mike Cacciotto. But now it's dumped off towards the net of Chris Mallon, and it will be an icing, something that we saw Illinois do quite often in the beginning of the first period. They had some icing calls, and they kind of froze those out as the first period went along. But early on here, we've seen one happen 2 minutes in.
Yeah, I mean, stoppages of play are going to happen, but we've still seen no penalties, which I think plays into the Illini a little bit well. And I'm still caught up in that whole grand slam thing. I'm thinking now it might be a goal, assist, a save, and a block.
Oh, goodness. I got you all distracted now. As Illinois got it in the defensive zone, Opilka skating around Joe Molfetta. As Illinois has got Thomas Kolaz on offense right now, Opilka skating towards the slot. No pass there from Kolaz. Is hit off the boards there by Chris Skordilis of the Eagles. And we will have an icing on Robert Morris, 17:24 left. And the second period has kind of started off similarly to the first. A lot of early stoppages and probably 6-7 minutes of real time, and we've only not even 3 minutes of game time has expired.
Yeah, we're creeping into that same scenario we started with last period, but hopefully we'll have a goal in this period, because that'll kind of change the mantra we've kind of set early on.
Yeah, Ernsting was open in the slot, loses his stick. It actually breaks at the handle, so he's skating back for a new one. Nolan now in the defensive zone looking for it, hits the board hard on the floor, and it looks like we are going to have, I believe, our first penalty, as I think we're going to get a cross-checking call on Scott Koash. And Illinois, I think, are going to have a power play here early in the second period.
Especially at the Big Pond, the Illini have been really good on the power play. But one of the things is, on their power play, they like to set up Ribba in the slot for some nice wristers backside. And that's something they can't do on this particular power play because Ribba's not dressed today. We'll see who will step in and potentially score a goal on this one.
So the penalty was actually on Dom Minocchio. We'll let you know exactly what the penalty is in quite a bit. But 17:08 left in the second period. First power play for Illinois. Yeah, it is a cross-checking penalty on Dom Minocchio. So Illinois on the power play now. They are pretty effective on the power play at home as Opilka's out there with Ernsting. In Ribba's jersey, though, that is Michael Lenzi, and you've also got Moskaluk and Forfar on the ice as Robert Morris finally get their first clearance of the power play. Barnhart's going to get the puck, hit it behind his net, grabbed by Opilka with a minute 25 left in the power play, 16 and a half in the second period. It is the first penalty of this hockey game, and it comes 23 minutes in. Illinois moving it around now, that right circle. Moskaluk dumping it across the ice, but it's going to fly all the way back, and now skating for it is a Robert Morris player. It's Scott Koash who gets it. Acute angle shorthanded shot. Easy grab for Barnhart. A minute 03 left on the power play.
You're going to have the best luck on a power play when you set up shop from the point and kind of get the puck moving, and that's something the Illini haven't been able to do so far this power play.
That is one. I mean, Illinois has been able to score on power plays at home, but one thing that has been a struggle for them is getting shots, a lot of shots off of power plays. They still don't have one, as Opilka getting it to Stephen Quinn. 40 seconds left on the power play as Illinois finally able to slow it down and try and set up a shot here. Here's Kolaz near the right circle, passing it right into the middle of the ice there to Charlie Sulk. Now Kolaz looking for a pass to the slot. There's far post shot from Nolan. Can't get it towards net, and it's finally cleared away by Sam Turner. 20 seconds left on the power play. Illinois going to try and get one last chance here with a man advantage.
The Illini were finally able to set up shop in that specific rush, and that was something you like to see.
Richter dumping it off, two left on the power play. Nolan is going to settle it now. Salker, full strength again, trying to deflect it in. Richter was in front of the net as the penalty kill is successful for the Robert Morris Eagles here with less than 15 minutes to go in the second period in a scoreless game. Holt shot, and it's saved by Barnhart on the side, trying to keep it from the line. I think his glove was just in front of the line, able to keep it out, so Jake Barnhart making another very athletic acrobatic save as Illinois may be trying to get an odd man rush going now. Kolaz with a pass. Quinn is onside open. Kolaz dummies it as Sulk is on that right side. Sulk with a shot, hits off the back of Kolaz and finally frozen by Malin. 14:35 left. Both goaltenders still keeping their shutouts.
Yeah, and a one-shot power play is no way to break a shutout. I think that's something that if the Illini get the chance again, they're definitely going to have to address, and maybe Fabrini will have to go over something in the practice upcoming, but a one-shot power play is not something you like to see.
But something you do like to see if you're either team is the lack of penalties. Is an open net there. Novacell couldn't get a stick on it, and now a two-on-two here as Hart skating up ice with a teammate shot. Barnhart comes up and grabs it, and that shot came from Scott Koash. 14:23 left. But that's something Illinois has definitely improved on from the last couple of games. Fabrini's side, they got a little bit flustered against a very physical Central Oklahoma team, got a lot of penalties in that second game here at the Big Pond. But against Lindenwood also, they've had some penalties. Illinois still with no penalties on them almost 26 minutes into this contest as they win the defensive zone faceoff as Hatton passes it to the very speedy Evan Sabo. Rizzo is there. Sabo loses the stick but immediately picks it up off the ice. Novacell gets it, and there is Sabo grabbing it, looking for a center pass. No one in the slot yet. Homerin now skating in there, but now grabbed by the Eagles, trying to move it out, still with the Illini in the blue line. Graham is going to skate back, though, to avoid an offside.
I think one of the biggest things about the Illini without penalties is they've still been able to be physical, which is one of the things that they've always gotten penalized for. It was always hits and checks that they got penalized for, or potentially fighting.
Awkward deflection chance for Robert Morris. Couple of weird deflections that look like just off of the pipe of Barnhart's net, as Robert Morris was just flinging it up ice there.
Good thing happened, you throw the puck towards the net.
Robert Morris trying to settle it. There's a good hit there from Chance Homerin. Pass comes through the net. Homerin trying to get it. Kolaz was in front there. But finally, Robert Morris able to grab the puck again as Manocchio, who's the only player that's had a penalty called on him, passes it over the hand of Justin Reese. And now Molfetta has it, trying to move by Paul Prikos, who finally clears it out. Homerin trying to get after it. And now we got a tussle on the boards. Puck pops out to Martin, but it hits off the stick of his, and now it's going to go all the way back to Skordilis in the defensive zone, trying to cross-ice pass, hits off of Quinn. Malin getting it, though, behind his net. Good pressure from Stephen Quinn, as there's a bit of a scramble for the puck right now, finally taken by Robert Morris. The puck was flying in there for Nitschke, unable to get it, and the clock stops at 12:44.
Centerman Chance Homerin, he had a really, really good defensive showing there. He delivered two hits in a span of about 4 seconds. a physical player looking really good for the Illini right now.
Little Ozzy Osbourne being played here as we got another faceoff taking place. Won by Robert Morris, now center ice to Stover. And now Holt is just going to fling it. Barnhart with good control behind his net and misdirected by Jack Graham, trying to win possession and keep possession for Illinois. Richter trying to get through a couple of maroon shirts here, but now it's flung towards Nolan, still in the defensive zone. Good skating there from Joe Nolan. Now you've got Forfar and Richter to his right side. Gets into the offensive zone. Still with Joe Nolan. Pass to the middle to Forfar. He couldn't get a touch on that. A lot of passes now towards the front of the net for Illinois, but unable to get some clear shots. Stephen Quinn trying to get a deflection off of there, but he cannot. And Illinois keeping it in the corner there.
Looked like in period two, the game plan kind of changed to put more bodies in front of Malin, just throw pucks there, see what they can do.
Nolan now with a shot, and it's a good block there on the ice by Dylan Holt as he just kind of dove down there.
If I'm not mistaken, Holt made that diving poke check in the first period, so he's been putting on a clinic defensively for the Robert Morris Eagles.
Robert Morris now trying to get a shot off into the left circle, pass towards the front of the net, pops out as skating in front of Barnhart was Scott Koash. Couple of players on the ice now, but Stephen Quinn finally gets it, and now Moskaluk is trying to get by two defensemen, looking for an open shot, can't get the wrist. Good poke check from Rizzo, as Moskaluk was not able to get a clear shot there. Now Robert Morris moving it down ice with Dahlberg. Good pass into the middle to Cacciato. And there is Ken Dottie moving it back. Moskaluk center pass to Opilka. Now in the neutral zone is Bobby Ernsting. Ernsting moving it with Lenzi to his left. Ernsting can't get a shot. Good defending once again from Rizzo as the Robert Morris defensemen have been able to block shots and sort of contain and push the Illini players towards the wrong side of their shooting hands.
Moskaluk's still out there. He's got a little bit of an extended shift right now. I think that's two in a row for him.
Chance for Robert Morris in front of net. The net dislodged there. Center pass by Robert Morris. No one was in front of net. Puck was open for the taking, but Barnhart kind of hit the post there, dislodging the net just slightly. That'll stop the clock and give us a faceoff here with 10:41 left as both goaltenders are trying to go a half an hour without conceding a goal.
Going back to Moskaluk, I noticed one thing. He was able to generate a chance all by himself, allowed the rest of his team to change. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to get off of ice, but look, he's got the puck
Moskaluk
again.
Moskaluk again, one-on-one. Moskaluk wrist shot hits off of the feet of the Robert Morris defender. Looked like came off of Minocchio. But now Illinois passing it around the point. There's a nice shot there. Good save from Malin as that came from Ken Dottie from the blue line. Moskaluk trying to backhand. Another good save from Malin with the pad as he's been able to make save after save. Robert Morris trying to move down ice. Good defending there from Illinois. Lenzi passing it to Ernsting. Ernsting trying to get by his defenseman. Malin is going to freeze it with 10:04 left in the second period. 8:08 local time.
Moskaluk finally hops off the ice, but you saw a lot of physicality on his shift along with three offensive chances. Moskaluk is looking good right now, and I think he's kind of taking the role as the guy that's going to stand in front of the net, maybe look for some deflections, some open pucks, and just whack them towards Malin. So far, it's working.
Face-off between Koash and Novosel. Won by Novosel. Good shot there. And that came from Vince Avino, who's on the ice now for Illinois.
This is his first time out there. He's been the 13th skater for the Illini. Finally getting some ice time here midway through the second period.
Sulk shot. Avino looking for a deflection. Malin had to get up there a little bit and make a save. As Illinois has been able to keep some possession here, probably had a little bit of the better end of offense here, but Robert Morris has been defending well, and Chris Malin has been making some good saves. He's had a little bit more of the workload here halfway through the second period. 9.5 minutes to go now. Novosel trying to center it to Avino. Now a pass. What a poke check dive there by Josh Hart. As Charlie Sulk was trying to get a pass to the point, Hart just kind of dove there like a web gem grab reach, and it's called for an icing.
And we're back to baseball terms. I love it.
Right, but the effort of these Robert Morris players to just keep the puck away from Malin's net has been extraordinary. Guys are falling on the ice. Their poke checks are timed to perfection, and they're just giving 100%. They gave up six yesterday, and they're hoping they can keep this shutout tonight.
Yeah, they look like a totally different team from yesterday, which is why I think it was important that the Illini look at a 4-7 team and don't take them lightly. This team is playing just as good a game, if not better, than the Illini right now.
Some passing between Koash and Holt now as they're trying to get it out of their defensive zone. Good moving and skating there from Holt as he passes it right into the stick of Kolaz, who intercepted that pass. Illinois trying to keep it alive there with Chance Homerin, but now Homerin back to defending with Nolan and Graham back there, but Nolan and Graham finally able to settle it down and recollect it, but Nolan slips, and a potential breakaway chance here for Robert Morris, one-on-one, saved by Barnard, another chance, and it's wide, another chance for Robert Morris, Barnard's down, he scores, but it's a loose net, so what a scramble there. Robert Morris had a clear breakaway, Sam Mancini was wide open there, and then there was a couple more chances, and then Barnhart hits his net, dislodging it, stopping the clock at 8:42. Goodness me, that Joe Nolan slip probably scared this entire crowd.
Yeah, and if there's anybody good to have back there, it's Barnhart. Three great saves there, along with a good net dislodge, if you could say that. Stopped the momentum a little bit after he made three outstanding saves, one of them acrobatic, just like we saw earlier this period.
Yeah,
back
one
in the first.
A one-on-one save. I mean, we just haven't seen one-on-ones as often at this arena in general. Just a freak thing that happened there for Joe Nolan, who had just slipped on his skates there as Kolaz. Moving up that offensive zone, trying to center it to Reese, unable to get the touch off, but Luke Forfar is there to keep it inside the territory of the Illini in the offensive zone. Kolaz and Martin going at each other, Forfar and Rizzo joining the pile. And now Kolaz moving it around. He's got Nolan at the point. Opilka is there too. Passing around the net, Martin able to intercept it, Quinn trying to get it, and now Rizzo is going to try and skate past Quinn. A couple of hits there from Quinn. He's down on the ice still, trying to get that poke check. Unable to. Rizzo been able to keep the puck. Good center pass, and that was to Walton, who was unable to get a shot off. Finally cleared out, but it goes out of play. 7:57 left as Quinn and Rizzo now one-on-one-ing each other. Quinn throwing a little left-hand baby hook.
I don't know if it's something to mention, but earlier today when they were warming up, they have this part where they have every player take a one-on-one shot against the starting goalie. And I might add that Barnhart did not let one in, so maybe that practice paid off here in the second period.
And if we do go into a shootout, the way that these goalies are playing, they're just so in form right now, we could potentially see, a long shootout if we get to that point right now. As the referee's talking to the players right now, just making sure to avoid some scuffles, as we could potentially have a Robert Morris penalty here.
Looks like Quinn's safe. He's in the bench right now, not in the box.
Still don't know. The box door is open. It's just whether or not a Robert Morris player is going to enter it, as right now the officials are discussing a potential penalty and maybe just physicality warning to Robert Morris head coach Billy Carr. As this stopping the clock at 7:57. Not going to be as long of a stoppage as the legendary Central Oklahoma stoppage of 2 weeks ago where the board was being fixed and Steven and I were yabbing. I don't know what yabbing is. Yapping for 25, 30 minutes. And there is the fate of the Robert Morris player. He is in the box. I believe it is Ryan Martin getting the penalty. So Illinois is going to have a second power play here in the second period. They still have not committed a penalty.
Somehow, right? I don't know how Quinn didn't end up in the box. Might have been something after that little scuffle.
He kind of threw like a little punch there a little bit. Not like, going after him. Just like a little, hey, I'm here. Don't mess with me kind of.
He was also the one that threw him to the ground early in that little scuffle, but he'll stay safe.
So Martin is not in the box. There are five skaters out for Robert Morris, so this just could potentially be a five-minute penalty. We'll get confirmation very shortly on that. There's a little bit of confusion between the coaches and the crowd as well.
Looks like Malin's fixing his equipment as well.
So a bit of a momentum killer, this stoppage of play, but we'll see who comes out of it still skating well. As there's another stoppage of play immediately after that faceoff. Malin maybe not fixing his gear quickly enough.
Six Robert Morris players on the ice right now.
Yeah, I think Josh Hart just went on the ice for some referee clarification. There isn't a power play. It is a 5-on-5 right now, so I think the Robert Morris player in the box trying to make out who the number is cannot right now.
Looks like number 16, Nick Rizzo.
Yeah, Nick Rizzo.
Oh, it's a misconduct.
Misconduct. So that's a 10-minute penalty potentially for Nick Rizzo, who's been playing pretty well today.
Yeah, he's been everywhere defensively.
Lindsay now skating around. He's getting a lot of work in there as Moskala gets the puck now. We got 7.5 minutes to go. Pluck flings in the air, hits in neutral zone ice. Opilka is able to grab it. So Robert Morris losing a player for misconduct for an extended period of time. Ken Dottie now skating past that blue line. On Skordilis, his shot is wide. Grabbed by Opilka as it just kind of careened off of the boards there. Pass around to the back of the net to Lenzi. Ernsting looking for it. As Moskaluk out there with Ernsting, Opilka, and Mark Ken Dottie, as Ken Dottie passing it towards the net.
It's good when you have a guy like Ken Dottie who's a defenseman that can also play some offense. It's always good to have that versatility on the ice.
Tony Dahlberg just does sort of a pop fly dump to help Robert Morris get a line chase here as he skates his way to the bench. But Opilka gets it now, 6.5 minutes to go in the second. We still haven't had a goal yet in this game. Illinois has never had a scoreless game at the Big Pond this season. And they've only had three shutouts at the Big Pond, one against Michigan State, the one last night, and one against Illinois State. The lowest amount of goals they've scored in a 60-minute time frame in the Big Pond this season is 2, because they've just been so good at home so far. But Robert Morris defensively have been tremendous so far, and Chris Mallon is having a great game too. 6 minutes left in the second period.
It's almost been parallels. Both teams have been playing generally the same game. Really good goaltending, solid defense. Offensive chances are there, just no capitalization.
Right, and Barnhart's had to make one key save. Mallon's had to make a lot more. Kolas now shot from the slot, deflecting. Crowd thought it could have been going in, but it doesn't, as Homer in now gets it for Kolas. And there's a nice hit there from Robert Morris defender. As Molfetta now moving it around. Molfetta's got a nice move from Molfetta. Molfetta looking for a shot, and he scores! Joe Molfetta from his own defensive zone all the way down the ice, moving past the defender, and just like that, Robert Morris has taken the lead here at the Big Pond.
Yeah, and Molfetta was the guy who delivered the hit in the corner like we saw. Came skating up the ice, delivered a phenomenal deke to one of the Illini defenders, freed himself up and buried it in the back of the net. Barnhart didn't necessarily see it coming, but regardless, it's 1-0 Robert Morris Eagles. 5:28 to play in the second period. Let's see if the Illini can get something cooking and neutralized before the break.
So a 1-0 lead now for Robert Morris. Almost another chance there for Hart.
Nolan looks a little sloppy.
Yeah, Nolan's had some slipping trouble, and now another chance. Robert Morris trying to get one. Still with the puck now is Hart, as they're trying to get two in quick succession. Molfetta now with 3 goals this season. His first name is Giuseppe Molfetta. I'm going to call him that from now on because that's an awesome name. As Robert Morris taking the surprising lead, as this is the first time Illinois has been down at home since that first game against Central Oklahoma when they were down 2-0 2 weeks ago. Hart trying to get around Graham. Barnhart just kind of flings it around the ice, so no shutout for Barnhart, but Mallon is looking to keep his as Robert Morris is trying to get their 5th win this season. It would also be their 5th win on the road because this Eagles team has not won a game at home now, but Illinois trying to recollect the puck. They do, as Forfar is at the blue line now. How will Illinois respond to the very out-of-the-blue goal from Robert Morris? Stephen Quinn's got it. Pass to the point to Ken Dottie. Ken Dottie's shot wide of the net.
I don't know if you can ever blame a goal on something, but that whole stoppage of play really killed the Illini's momentum, and that was right when Robert Morris kind of took over and were able to capitalize, bury one. I think it's key to get the momentum back for the Illini if they want to neutralize and get a lead in this game.
4:09 left in the second period as Illinois trying to avoid their first home loss of the season and what would be their 3rd loss in their last 4. They got swept by Lindenwood last weekend in St. Louis. But still a lot of time left in this game. We've seen the Illini come out with some rabbits out of hats before, and there's still time in this period if they want to tie this game, as the puck floating by itself, gliding by itself. Ken Dottie finally getting it. Holt trying to clear it out. Puck kind of staying there and chipping it. Try and get it by was Vince Avino. And now we finally have the stoppage of play, 3:42. So we're going to have another line change here and a face-off near the neutral zone with 3:42 to go. First period went by a little bit faster than this second period just because we've had those stoppage of plays, we had the goal, and we've had the penalty. We do have someone in the box for misconduct, which is Nick Rizzo of Robert Morris. And even with one less man in the rotation for line changes, Joe Molfetta or Giuseppe Molfetta, whichever one you prefer, was able to get that first goal to give Robert Morris the lead here, as Robert Morris now have it in the offensive zone.
And he definitely earned that goal, too. Beautiful stick handling. He worked the puck all the way from his defensive zone into the slot. Good goal there by Molfetta.
And made a great move as well. With 3:17 to go now in the second period, Illinois going to make a defensive change with Nolan and Graham coming in, as Kendati and Opilka will go to the bench, as we got a face-off in the Illini defensive zone. It's a big conference game for Illinois, as Graham skating it up down that right board. No offside on the play, as Robert Morris now going to move it up ice. Here comes Molfetta again, trying to move by a couple bodies, unable to keep the puck close to his stick that time. Now here's John Moskaluk. He scored yesterday in the 6-0 win. Around the net, trying to get a little wrap around there. Now Lenzi able to get it. Pass to Nolan. Another slip from Joe Nolan. He might have a skate issue potentially, because he slipped a couple of times in this game and in the second period specifically, as Moskaluk has it now, passing it around. Skorillis behind the net, glove goes down. It is the glove of Bobby Ernsting. Picks it up, puts it right back on. Robert Moore still hasn't been able to clear their lines yet. Finally, John Moskaluk gets it, dumps it behind the net. Ernsting now collects it, passing it towards the middle of the crease. No Illini player there to get a touch off. Minocchio with a nice little hit on Jack Graham, just to shake him up a little bit. Now Robert Morris trying to move it around. Good stick handling from Nitschke, as he's just trying to get some more bodies there, but his pass right into the stick of Ernsting. One on two as Thomas Kolaz goes up against two Eagles defenders. Kolaz, line change there, and there's a wide shot that came from the stick of Chance Homer, and now another chance wide for Illinois, as they've quickly responded after this goal, trying to get a lot of shots off, and they have, as Homerin gets it now, skating towards the middle of the ice. Trying to find Opilka, who's moving around. Homer and shot, save off the stick, and the pad of and there's a nice slap shot there from Evan Sabo. He wasn't able to get it on target. Opilka's going to skate all the way back to his defensive zone to get it with 1:40 to go in the second period. Kolaz, cross ice pass. It's going to be collected by Dylan Holt, but Illinois going to get it back in that neutral zone, trying to dump it off. A lot of action here right now. Now Thomas Kolaz has got Chance Homer in the slot. Kolaz, wrist shot. Good save from Malin, who is still keeping that net empty.
I'm going back a couple of minutes, but it was a really good job by John Moskaluk. Had the puck at the point, dumped it back in. He knew that the Robert Morris defenders were a little bit tired, probably overshifted at that point, and the dump in kept them in the zone a little bit longer, allowed the Illini to get some more offensive chances. So really smart play by Moskaluk.
First forward line out there for Illinois, as Forfar is going to have this face-off against Mike Cacciato in the Illini offensive zone. It is won by Robert Morris. We talked about how good Illinois is on face-off, but they've actually lost quite a few in this game, as Robert Morris have just looked like a completely different team tonight than they did last night. Defending very well, and of course have the lead right now after Joe Molfetta's goal. 15 minutes into this second period, as Robert Morris have got about a minute left, maybe trying to get this 2-0 lead. They just dump it off into the defensive zone. No icing called as Tyler Opilka gets it. Passing it to what looks like Charlie Salk. Forfar now moving it around. Good little screen there from Stephen Quinn to give him some space. Puck floating around, and now potentially a one-on-one chance as Dahlberg is skating it around the ice. He's got support on his left side. Dahlberg, pass to Cacciato in front of net, and he tries to get it in, but it is wide. Another really good breakaway chance for Robert Morris. 35 seconds left now in the second period.
Salk did just enough there to slow the puck down. I think that was key in making sure.
Richter moving in the slot, trying to get a shot. Another block, and Quinn gets it. And saved by Malin. Drew Richter trying to get that goal, but another diving effort block from a Robert Morris defender.
Yeah, you see that a lot. They're sacrificing their body to do anything to keep the pucks away from the Illini. And I think that was the biggest thing. Yesterday, the Illini controlled the puck, had a lot of offensive chances. And today, I think the the game plan is keep the puck away from the Illini sticks, and they've done pretty well.
26 seconds flat. Faceoff won by Bobby Ernsting, but it's popped out and grabbed by Molfetta, who's just going to clear it out. Grabbed by Graham, 15 seconds left, enough for maybe a late second period Illini equalizer as we're almost 40 minutes into this game. Ernsting moving up ice, moving around some defenders, but now it's grabbed by Robert Morris. Nitschke with Molfetta coming up ice, but Graham is right in front of him. 1 second left in the period, and the buzzer sounds, and 40 minutes in, and Robert Morris, after a phenomenal individual goal by Giuseppe Molfetta, and the Eagles will go into the locker room with 20 minutes left in this game with a 1-0 lead as they've played great in these first 40 minutes.
Yeah, that's definitely something they wanted to do. They wanted a lead because every team's better when they score, right? But you look at the Illini, they still played a really good second period, in my opinion. They had kind of one fluky play, and that was that goal by Giuseppe Molfetta there. He kind of started in his own zone, nifted past a couple of defenders, put a great move on and scored a goal, but the Illini looked really good. They were on the attack pretty much the whole period except for that last half. And I think we'll look for a third period to be filled with a lot of Illini goals.
Illini going to have to...
A lot of shots, I mean.
Yeah, shots, potentially goals. We'll have to see as Nick Fabrini's going to have to change the strategy a little bit as Illinois right now, potential threat of losing their first home game this season on this Saturday on Dad's Weekend. It is 1-0 Robert Morris at the end of the second period. We'll be back in a bit with our intermission report. 1-0 Eagles after two.
We'll come.
And welcome back inside the Big Pond. My name is Anthony Pasquale alongside Claire O'Brien, and this is your second period intermission report presented by YouTube. Claire, what'd you think of that second period?
My mic wasn't on, but I think it was very uncharacteristic of the Illini, if I can even use that term. Typically, you see the Illini dominating on offense. It's a lot of times what you're accustomed to. They haven't dropped a game here at the Big Pond. So I think what we saw out there was, more like the offense and the defense were quite as strong as what people here are used to seeing, I think.
Yeah, it's definitely odd to see the Illini go into the second break down a goal, but I mean, the goaltending today by both teams has still been fantastic. It's been a great hockey game. What have you seen personally out of Jake Barnhart?
I think Barnhart, I've seen some very close calls and very, one time they were going to score and then Barnhart saved it. And, I thought it was in, but it wasn't, obviously. So I've seen really strong goaltending out of Barnhart. And, Barnhart is a very strong goaltender in general. But also on the offensive end, typically the first line has scored 14 goals cumulatively this season, and the second line has scored 15 goals. But neither line, in fact, none of the lines have scored tonight.
Yeah, and I mean, it's kind of tough to say that the first line has scored 14 goals, considering I believe 6 or 7 of those are missing from Kasper Ribba's stick. But of course, it's one of those things you see when you have a good goaltender like Christopher Malin for the Robert Morris Eagles, you can shut down just about any offense. And the Illini offense, which has been really good, especially here at home at the Big Pond, where they have not yet dropped a game this season, shutting them out for 2 straight periods is an accomplishment in and of itself. But a third period for the Illini should be a good one, I think.
Yeah. And then how do you think offensively that's going to look? Do you think that, Moskalek so far has 8 goals for the season. Do you think he'll score in the third?
I mean, if I'm putting money on anybody, I'm putting money on John Moskalek. He has been everywhere on that ice, doing everything Coach Fabrini's asking him to. We saw him delivering a couple of hits midway through the second period. We saw him with a couple of very smart dump-ins to keep the puck in the zone. And we also see him right next to the goalie, potentially screening or finding loose pucks and just whacking them away. I think he's one of the Illini's best offensive weapons, and he's the one that can generate a chance all by himself, and those are the most dangerous. So I think he's somebody that you should definitely look out for in the third period to potentially score a goal, equalize this game.
Yeah, and then typically a lot of times on this intermission report and just in general, we see a lot of Kasper Ribba, and he didn't suit up tonight. Do you think that Moskalek is the player that would step up in his place, if you will?
Yeah, I mean, Moskalek's definitely one of them, and he's done so far. He's kind of filled the skates there. But also, Lenzi's also been playing a really good game, kind of serving that first-line spot that Kasper Ribba does. Maybe doesn't shoot as well, but he's setting up guys like Ernsting and Moskalek with those chances. And I think another guy that you can look out for is Drew Richter. He was a big scorer last year. Kind of got off to a little bit of a slow start this year, but he netted 2 yesterday, so he's kind of finding his stride a little bit this season, and he's a dangerous player when he gets hot.
Yeah. And
another thing I was going to say is, with a goaltender like Malin, you kind of got to change your strategy a little bit if you want to try to generate some chances. We saw the first period seeing more of the same from the Illini, set up from the point, dump it in a little bit. Second period, we saw more people in front of the net trying to get it moving a little bit, looking around those guys. What do you think is the key in the third period to maybe get some goals or at least some better chances on Malin?
I think a lot of times, though, you'll see a lot of defensemen hanging very close to the goal. So the Illini have to pass a little bit more cleanly. There was a play in the first period, I believe, where Quinn passed it, but it got intercepted. So, the Illini have to make more crisp passes and look for any opportunities and just go for it, I think, is probably the best strategy to equalize and hopefully get out of here with that overtime.
Yeah, and I want to say it's one of the things, we play at the Big Pond, like we said, it's a bigger ice rink. There's more skating space, so use it. Spread yourselves out a little bit. As long as you're still nailing those crisp passes, like you said, Claire, if you can deliver good passes from tape to tape, you're going to allow yourself to expand this ice and make sure to the goalie it looks as big as it is. So he's moving laterally, right and left, up and down, peering around guys, trying to find a place in the net that's open, and then capitalize by just putting the puck in the back of it. I think that's all the time we have here for the second period intermission report. For Claire O'Brien, my name is Anthony Pasquale. Me and Ori have the call in the third period, and we'll be back on YouTube right after this.
Back at the Big Pond here, Ori Benatar and Anthony Pasquale as we are getting ready for the third period of hockey here at the Illinois Ice Arena. What has happened in the first 40 minutes of this game? Well, Illinois is losing 1-0. A phenomenal individual goal by Joe Giuseppe Molfetta. I think we should probably say Giuseppe Joe Molfetta. We'll say it's his fake middle name. I mean, his name is Giuseppe, but in short, he is called Joe. 3 goals this season. A tremendous goal by Molfetta in general in that second period. And shutout for Chris Mallon through 2 as this Robert Morris team is trying to hand Illinois their first home loss of this season.
Yeah, and like you said with Molfetta, you usually don't see that good of a goal with that good of stick handling by a defenseman. He literally took it, like they say in basketball, coast to coast, and that's something you usually don't see from a defenseman unless you're playing NHL. So that's one of those things that you see. Maybe it's something you won't see again, but he's definitely a player that could do it like we saw. But I think in this third period, it's going to be key for the Illini. Just pepper Mallon with shots because he's been electric so far, as had Barnhart been. But I think the key is making sure Mallon sees more shots. The more shots he sees, the better percentage that one of them is going to trickle in.
And so far in this game, the only stoppages have really come from icing, and there have only been 2 penalties in this game. There was a cross-check by Dom Minocchio, which has led to the only power play of the game. The other penalty, with a man still in the box, Nick Rizzo, a 10-minute misconduct penalty that came in the middle of the second period. So Illinois still have not gotten a penalty called on them. We'll see if that happens in the third. But I think their biggest concern, obviously, is going to be trying to get that equalizing goal to try and keep this home record, this undefeated home record, I should say, intact. As we're ready for the faceoff here in the third period, it will be 4-4. And it's won by Jack Nitschke of Robert Morris, as the Eagles have done a really good job on the faceoffs today. And what has been a really good performance from Robert Morris, but they've got 20 more minutes to try and keep this lead and get their 5th win of the season. They've won all of 4 of their games on the road this year. As a pass in the middle, looking for Drew Richter, there was Luke Forfar, but no one there to touch the puck. Early chance there for Illinois, but Robert Morris skating it down quickly. Ken Dottie gonna pass it off to Quinn, but lost there and flung into the boards by Chris Skordilis.
We'll see the Illini going back the way they're more used to here at the Big Pond, see if that has anything to do with their offensive chances.
Opilka around, grabbed by Stover. Tyler Opilka there to get it, now Forfar. Pass around to John Moskaluk. He's had a pretty good game, gotten a lot of chances for the Illini as Illinois just trying to keep the puck with them, but skaters are going to have to come back to avoid an offside as Joe Nolan's got it. Everyone back behind the blue line. Nolan skating past the blue line, shot deflected into the nets of the boards. As 1:04 has gone in this final period, 1-0 to the Eagles.
I mean, I'm going to take a positive off of that. It's good to see Joe Nolan going into the offensive zone, because we saw him in the second period staying kind of back towards the point, being very timid and kind of slipping around a lot. So I think that was a good aggressive play by Joe Nolan, something we haven't seen.
Faceoff won by Ernsting, but it will have to be redone. As Ernsting has been able to win a lot of faceoffs like he usually does, but I think Luke Forfar's
had a little bit of a struggle.
He's had a struggle with the faceoff so far. Nolan with the send-in shot towards the slot. Ernsting in front of net. Can't get a deflection, but Illinois keep the puck now. Illinois in their whites, maroon jerseys for the Eagles. A great block by Josh Hart as Graham wristed it from the blue line. Phenomenal defending continuing in this third period, a theme for Robert Morris. Moskaluk centers it off of the stick of Mallon. Now a hard slap shot by Jack Graham goes out of play with 18:26 left. So Illinois, first 1.5 minutes of this third, it's been all Illini.
Yeah, and the defensemen on the Eagles have played phenomenal all day. I mean, Skordilis, and Holt have all had a lot of blocks. They've been keeping the pucks away from their goaltender, and when the pucks have gotten there, Mallon's capitalized and made every save.
Faceoff going to be in the Illini offensive zone between Cacciotto and, I think, Chance Homerin. Graham flinging it around towards Thomas Kolas, but a stoppage of play there. Going to be another faceoff.
I think they got Graham for an offsides there. Didn't quite keep the puck in. Made it look like he did, but I think puck seeped over the blue line.
Now there's going to be a faceoff in center ice. near the middle of the ice as a great Dire Straits song plays. As Illinois have it now in the offensive zone. Still with the Illini. Shot then coming in from Justin Reese. But it's wide, and it's going to go all the way back into the defensive zone. Picked up by Jack Graham, who's going to hit it off of the boards. But it's going to go right to Cacciotto as Robert Morris get the puck now finally. But it's actually grabbed by Joe Nolan. Off the board pass to Kolas. Very good pass from Nolan. Kolas trying to get it around his defender. Support there from Homerin. Homerin back to Kolas, who can't connect on the shot there. Two on two now for Robert Morris. Cacciotto trying to get past Opilka. Cacciotto shot save off of Barnhart's pad. Pass back into the neutral zone from Robert Morris as Lucas Stover had it, and he just dumps it off. Barnhart getting it behind his net and passing it to Charlie Sulk. Now Reese has it on the ice with Novacell, Hatton, Opilka, and Sulk. But Reese is going to come off the ice now for a quick change. And coming back in is Evan Sabo. Shot from Nitschke is wide.
Sabo's one of those guys that can provide a spark just because of how quickly he skates. He's got a really good wrister. Let's see if he can put that into action.
Hatton shot from a tough angle, saved by Malin, who freezes it with 17:11 to go in the third period.
Here's a little update. Rizzo is out of the box.
So there goes the misconduct penalty. So Nick Rizzo back in the game. He's played really well overall. He's had a good game before he had that misconduct penalty. So two penalties for Robert Morris, none for Illinois. Very different to the last time we broadcasted here at the Big Pond in that Central Oklahoma-Illinois game where there were like a million penalties and a lot of little altercations between the two teams as Kendati's going to dump it off. It hits off of the backboard, but it's going to be called an icing, stopping the clock at 16:57.
And it's one of those things, if you're the Illini, you've got to be a little bit upset about, because with that one penalty, you did nothing to capitalize on it. That power play consisted of one shot that wasn't even that high percentage, which is not typical for a power play. So the Illini didn't take advantage of what could have been their chance.
Another face-off win from Robert Morris, but quickly grabbed by Hatton as Rick Hatton moves it down, and another frozen puck from Chris Malin, who's had a very, very busy day. He came in to this game, or he came into the weekend series. His goals against average was over 5, to be exact. His stats coming into the series, he had played 4 games, he had a 1-2 record, a goals against average of 5.16, and an 84 save percentage. None of the Robert Morris keepers have a 90% save percentage that entering the series, but Malin's is about to go up through the roof after what's been a great performance as he's trying to keep this shutout here for the Robert Morris Eagles, a team that have not gotten a single shutout all season in any of their road wins, which has accounted for all of their victories this season. As Mancini dumps it off, Opilka gonna skate around to get it. Passing to Jack Graham, but it's a bit of a misconnect there. Now a chance, Cacciotto coming into the slot, shot! Tries to wrist it over Barnhart, but it's wide over the pipe as Forfar now gives it to Drew Richter, Quinn in front of him. Richter getting around his defenseman, looking for a center pass. Now tries it to Forfar, another good defensive play there from Robert Morris, but Graham's able to get it. Good grab with the hand by Dahlberg, but an offside call by the officials on Robert Morris.
Yeah, that was definitely the right play, trying to get it to Forfar there. He was wide open in the slot, probably would have had an open net. He was going to slam that one through. Just another great recovery by the Robert Morris defenders to keep the puck away and away from the sticks of the guys who could be scoring.
16 minutes left. I mentioned Robert Morris hasn't had a shutout this season. Illinois has not gotten shut out since their loss to Lindenwood just last weekend. So if Illinois does not score in this game, it would be the second time in 2 weeks that they've been shut out. They lost that Saturday game to Lindenwood 6-0 in St. Louis. Bobby Ernsting, nice moves there left and right around Martin. He skates towards the end of the net. Now looking for a shot right at the near post. Malin can't hold on to it quickly, but it's grabbed by Lenzi. Now Sulk. Cross ice pass. Nolan open for a shot. Makes a nice move. Joe Nolan with a shot there. Trying to whip it around. Now Sulk. He whiffs on a potential slap shot there, and he's going to have to go all the way back to the defensive zone.
Yeah, Malin was way off the net. He kind of slipped a little bit, and Sulk had an open chance that would have had to only get through the legs of one defender there. Missed opportunity by the Illini.
Now a one-on-one. Skating down. Nitschke with a shot. Crosses body wide of Barnhart's net. Moskaluk now flinging it up towards neutral zone. It goes by a Robert Morris defender. Now a chance for Lenzi, and it's wide of the far post as he was looking for the lower bottom 90 corner of that far post. Still with Illinois, Nolan behind the net looking to center it to Novacell. Now skating it towards that right circle. Back to Novacell now. He's now looking for a center pass. Misdirecting it and gives it to Nolan at the point. Kendon to the other side. Nolan looking for a deflection off of the stick of Homerin. Can't get it though. Puck still flopping around. And finally cleared out by Skordilis of Robert Morris.
And what a storyline Lindsay has been. He's really played a good game. Filling the skates of Casper Ribba. He's gotten a couple of good shots off. We'll see if he can keep it going.
Candotti's shot almost got through the legs of Malin, but Illinois is keeping the puck here. It's almost 6 minutes into the third period, and the Illini have had a good amount of the possession, but Robert Morris in the last couple periods have had the better chances as Candotti risks it, and it's grabbed by the glove of Chris Malin.
Now, this is the Illini we like to see. When they control the puck, they're a much different team and a much better team. If they can keep winning faceoffs and commanding their offensive zone, we should see a goal pretty soon.
Forfar, who struggled with faceoffs tonight. Big offensive zone faceoff here for Illinois. It is won by Forfar. Precos now hits off the stick of Forfar, goes to the behind the net. Richter tries to one-time it, but it's not a good connection there from Richter, not smooth enough, and it's blocked by a Robert Morris defender. And now they're trying to move it into the neutral zone. Koash has the puck now. He does get it past the red line, now past the blue line, and it's going to be a stoppage of play here, an offside call on Robert Morris with 13:48 to go.
Yeah, that's another stoppage of play, and I think that only benefits the Illini, keeping the Eagles out of their zone and potentially trying to get back into our offensive zone, which has been where we've been thriving in this third period.
Faceoff win for Illinois is Precos. Looking for Forfar in the middle of the ice. His pass is too far. No icing, though. So Robert Morris gets it back. Kolas trying to intercept it, but Robert Morris with some good poke checks. Now Salk gets one, but now Illinois able to recollect it as it's Thomas Kolas with a nice little backwards pass to Charlie Salk. Rissing it to Richter. Goes to Forfar. Now Forfar moving it around, creating some ice space for himself, and a very good grab there from Chris Malin with Thomas Kolas going in front of net. 13:22 left in Illinois. Has not been able to capitalize on any of their opportunities.
Yeah, Malin has been really good with his glove today, and I mean, really good with everything, like we were saying about Barnhart earlier, but his glove especially, if you're coming on that side of the ice, you're not gonna score a goal, especially not tonight. He's been really good with the glove.
And Illinois has been firing off a lot of shots, but Robert Morris, when they have chances, they're usually the better ones as a two-on-two is avoided here, and now we have a one-on-two, Moskaluk and Lenzi coming into support for Illinois. Ernsting laying off to Lenzi, comes center to Ernsting, but it goes by his skates. Recollected by Graham, who's trying to get it by. Still with Illinois, trying to win it back is Lenzi, but now it's going to be skated up by Cacciotto, past the neutral zone, dumps it off, trying to skate after it. Barnhart and Graham behind the net. Graham is going to get it now, passing it to Michael Lenzi. Puck going all the way down for an icing call with 12:42 left.
Yeah, that one just looked like a miscommunication there. Moskaluk kind of let it go between his legs. That would have been one for him to stop and maybe settle down, try to do a little bit more with it. But regardless, we're back in the defense here.
Another faceoff win by Bobby Ernsting, and Illinois will win it in the defensive zone, but the puck is still not controlled. Now finally is by Bobby Ernsting, passing it to Lenzi. Moskaluk gets hit there. Nice little check from Nick Rizzo, who's back into the game after his 10-minute misconduct penalty. Only two penalties called in this game, both on Robert Morris in the second period. There's only been one power play. No power plays for Robert Morris, but they have the 1-0 lead. Kendotti pass off the board to Opilka across the ice, loses control a little bit, but Homerin now gets it and skating it past into the offensive zone. Good speed from Homerin. Misdirect center pass, falls onto the boards. Illinois trying to get possession back, but the Eagles take it back from them. And now just going to skate it up ice. Center pass into the neutral zone. And now Novacell gets hit hard, but a stick of Ryan Martin flings into the Illinois offensive zone. So he's going to have to come off. Big collision there between Novacell and Martin as the puck is being fought through there. Looking for a deflection, but it flies over the corner there as Illinois once again in their offensive zone, trying to create some chances, trying to get that game-tying goal here with 11 and a half minutes left in the third period. The one goal by Joe Molfetta in late in the second on a phenomenal individual effort, the difference between the Eagles and the Illini tonight.
Yeah, and I think one of the things defensively that have been the difference between these two teams is the Illini being a quick skating team, the Eagles have excelled at limiting odd man rushes. And I think that's, besides that one to Stephen Quinn early, that's been a big reason why the Eagles have yet to give up a goal.
Whereas Robert Morris has had a couple of breakaways and two-on-ones in there.
Exactly.
Sulk. Quick change for Illinois as Richter's got it, trying to keep it. He does keep it. Well done from Drew Richter as he finds some space during a change from Josh Hart. Middle to Forfar, but he loses possession of the puck as once again Robert Morris is able to keep the puck away from the net, and an offside call, and it's going to be a faceoff in the Illinois offensive zone, or in the neutral zone, with 10:40 left.
How many times, Ori, today have you been saying, loses the puck, loses the puck? That's happened way too much for the Illini. That's something that they need to secure. The puck is the most important thing on the ice. They need to secure that if they want to break into this lead at all.
I think I need one of those counters to have to see how many phrases I say more often, because that will give us an idea of what's happening in the game. So, rough estimation, I'd probably say lose the puck maybe 30, 40 times.
Yeah.
That's probably an overestimation. Again, I'm not a math person. If anyone is listening to this and knows my broadcast, as there's a shot from Lindsay, easy save from Chris Mallon. Quick 7 seconds there after the faceoff. I also got to give props to whoever does the music at the Big Pond, because it's always money and awesome. And they got Tom Sawyer playing by Rush.
Yeah, whoever's running it is one of the only people I'd let have the aux in my car.
Nolan now in the blue line. His shot was deflected off of Turner. Now Dahlberg going after it. Passing it around behind the net, but now finally grabbed by Michael Lindsay. Kolas gets it off of the left side board. Now Nolan near the circle has a chance for a shot. Good save by Mallon. Puck is still alive and finally frozen by Mallon with 10-10 on the clock.
That whole play was generated by the Illini knowledge of how the puck will bounce off the boards here at the Big Pond. Bouncing it off to Kolas was the thing that made that chance a real chance. If they would have passed to Kolas, the angle probably would have been way off. So that was a great, great play there by the Illini defenseman, just knowing their home ice.
Faceoff win from Justin Reese. Quick shot off of the faceoff, but saved by Mallon. He's been phenomenal today. Definitely a contender for the number one star of this game, as Kolas misses shot there. It's actually Evan Sabo who had that chance. A couple of big hits near the boards as Sabo chasing after it with his teammate Justin Reese. Robert Morris moving it into the offensive zone. Here's the goal scorer, Joe Molfetta, trying to get the moves by Tyler Opilka, one of the assistant captains of Illinois. There's a shot, almost deflected. Oh, it's off by Barnhart, and he saves it with his glove. Still alive, and the net finally dislodges. Shot there from Tyler Kritis. Barnhart saved it, couldn't hold on to it. Puck was just lying there for a shot. Two Robert Morris players went after it, and then Barnhart extending his glove hand to stop it from the net. And for the third time today, Barnhart dislodging his net with 9:36 left in the third.
I mean, the big takeaway from that play is Barnhart's awareness on the ice. He knew something was wrong with that save. He didn't have the puck, and he was able to locate it and stop it from going in the net. Great play by Barnhart, and I feel like we've also said that a lot tonight.
Yeah, Barnhart's had to make more of the acrobatic saves, because Robert Morris's chances have just been those breakaways, puck in the middle of the net with no one in front of it, open net chances. And only one goal conceded in this game between either team. Barnhart tapping it, Graham trying to get it. He does eventually, and passing it to the other side with open ice to Neil Novosel. Chance homering in the middle there, skating with him. Novosel shot, easy save for Mallon, and he'll freeze it with 9:06 left. Besides me saying lose the puck a lot, I've probably said Chris Mallon freezes the puck 50 times.
Yeah, and I think it's one of the things that makes a goaltender a great goaltender. Most goals are scored off of second chance opportunities, and if you're the type of goalie that can control it, not have a lot of rebounds, and be able to freeze the puck in those situations, your team's going to have a better shot to win every single game.
Cole has had a shot that hit the side netting immediately after the offensive zone faceoff win from Illinois. Ernsting trying to get it. Another good defensive effort there from Robert Morris. Now around the net was Lenzi. Couldn't get a chance to get a shot as he was kind of wrapped around Stover. As now Illinois trying to win some possession here. Ernsting just flinging it to Joe Nolan. And Illinois is able to win the puck back. Center pass to Ernsting. Flying around. Kolas has it now. Cross ice. Shot from Ken Doty. Another good block there. That time from Tony Dahlberg. It's not just Malin making saves for the Eagles. It's all the players on the Eagles. A big hit from Joe Nolan on Sam Turner. Keeping the puck for Illinois. Ernsting looking for a pass. Finds it to Lenzi, back to Ernsting near the blue line. Off the skate of Kolas and a loss of possession for Illinois as Lucas Stovar is going to reset and slow it down for the Eagles with 8 minutes now in the third. Illinois desperately needing a goal as they're probably about 6 minutes away from taking Barnhart out of his net.
Maybe that hit by Nolan will be a key for momentum that the Illini need right about now. Great hit there by Joe Nolan.
Forfar to Reese now. Good clearance from Skordilis. Candotti defending now. Dumped off by the Eagles and grabbed by Charlie Sulk, who gives it to Justin Reese. Illinois is going to need some speed to get out of their defensive zone here as it's been staying here for about a minute. Reese now getting it. Skordilis, another clearance. Easy save for Barnhart as he just leans with his stick side. Richter now open with the puck. Good pass to Forfar, but he's unable to get a touch on it as the Robert Morris defenders force him away from the puck with 7 minutes to go in the third period. Skordilis against Forfar. Puck flings towards the crowd. About a couple seats to the left of us. We're up in the treehouse, of course, but rarely do we see pucks come towards this side of the crowd or just in general into the crowd, but an awkward bounce stops the play with 7:05 left.
Yeah, this period hasn't exactly gone the way the Illini have expected it to or wanted it to, but 7 minutes is a lot of time. We saw two Saturdays ago, they scored 2 goals in 70 seconds, so 7 minutes is a ton of time for the Illini to do some damage.
Offside on the Eagles, less than 7 minutes now on the clock. Robert Morris looking for their fifth win of the season, and by the way, For the first time since the very beginning of the season, Illinois are going to have back-to-back home series, as next weekend the Illini are going to host Alabama. So all you people who said we want Bama after the beginning of this football season or previous football seasons, you got Bama, but it's going to be on a sheet of ice next weekend. But Illinois first are going to try and keep their home undefeated record intact, and they have 6 minutes and 40 seconds to try and get a goal to maybe force overtime to have a chance at getting an eighth win at home. Opilka skating it by to Lenzi, who's going to pass it back to Sulk. Good pass from Sulk now to Homerin. Homerin trying to flip it to Opilka, hits off of a maroon shirt there. Now Charlie Sulk trying to reset it. His backhand pass off the stick of Minocchio. Lenzi trying to move by a defender. Good layoff pass there from Mancini. Dahlberg, center pass. Mancini trying to get it there. Now Ernsting re-getting it. Opilka against Dahlberg. Opilka wins that one, and now he's going to reset it for Charlie Sulk. Less than 6 minutes now in the third.
Nick Rizzo was the reason that chance got made. He delivered a big hit there on number...
Open opportunity for Illinois. Pass to Lenzi towards the front of the net. It's open in there, and the scuffle and the craziness does not ensue.
And now goalie pulled.
And a delayed penalty called. So Illinois have 6 men on the ice. Forfar back to Moskaluk. Illinois trying to keep the puck for as long as possible on this delayed penalty. They will have a power play. Next time, Robert Morris touches the puck. Ernsting cross ice to Graham. Illinois still with the puck here with 5:20 to go. Forfar, center of the blue line to Nolan. Bunch of Robert Morris players just parked in front of the net. Graham, Forfar, slap shot on over the bar. Still with Illinois as Kolas is getting it, as Illinois has been able to extend this delayed penalty for as long as they possibly can. As the net dislodges, and after a little bit of a crazy sequence there. 5:03 left, and it will be the second power play of the day. As going to the box will be Mike Cacciato, and Illinois has a power play. It will go from 5:03 to 3:03, and a massive chance for Illinois to try and tie this game.
Yeah, and you can feel it too, the buzz in the crowd right now. The Illini are gonna score a goal. They're meant to score a goal right now, and when they do, this crowd is going to erupt, and it's gonna be a great sight here. Hopefully we see it in the next 2 minutes. Illini power play was really bad last time, only one shot. Hopefully this one's a lot different.
And Illinois still hasn't been called for a penalty in this game. Penalty is hooking on Cacciato. And Illinois going to skate it up ice here. Opilka, Richter, Forfar, Ernsting, and Lenzi on the ice. Five-man line here, all symmetrical, if you like geometry. Opilka. Lenzi back to Opilka. Slap shot from Opilka and score! Power play goal for Illinois as Opilka's slap shot is deflected in by Luke Forfar, and we're tied late in the third.
And I told you this crowd was going to erupt. Can't you hear him? The big pond is going wild right now, and that play was all generated by the fact that the Illini generated an odd man rush by coming up the ice in a line of five people. They did the old three-man weave strategy from basketball, passed it to the open guy, and the net was open for whoever had the puck at that time. And Opilka delivered it, might have been redirected, but a goal for the Illini is all that we care about right now.
You cannot count out Illinois at the big pond. Luke Forfar deflecting in an Opilka shot for his fifth goal of the season. 29 seconds into the power play, and we're tied at one with 4.5 minutes left in the third period.
And I said pregame, keep an eye on Luke Forfar. He delivered there in that situation. Opilka with a great slap shot from the point. But as you can hear in this crowd, the Illini have all the momentum right now, and that's great to hear in the big pond.
We got another game here at the big pond once again. Shot from Nitschi is wide. Martin getting it back. Robert Morris trying to get some offensive momentum. They haven't been able to set up too many shots in this third period. Will we see a winner here with less than 4 minutes, or will we have overtime? Once again here at the big pond as Barnhart is going to grab it with his glove as this Illini crowd clapping it up after a big power play goal as Illinois have not even had to been on the penalty kill today. Haven't been on the penalty kill today. I got to correct my sentence there. It's exciting once again here. It's always exciting at the Illinois Ice Arena. Defensive zone faceoff win for Illinois. Opilka, who got the assist on the goal, passing it now. Hatton wasn't sure where the puck went, so Robert Morris getting it now in the neutral zone. About 3.5 minutes left in regulation. Could be overtime here, but Illinois with the tying goal from Luke Forfar just a minute ago. Sabo pass now to Hatton, trying to get by Holt, but another good defensive poke check there from Robert Morris. Holt trying to get by a couple of white shirts. He's unable to, but he will get it back after Illinois loses possession there. Hatton trying to block it with his hand. Robert Morris getting it back now. Cacciato, who had the penalty that gave Illinois that second power play, which led to the goal. Now a slap shot from distance. Oh, and it's just wide there from Robert Morris. Good chance there for the Eagles. And now Illinois trying to get it back. Evan Sabo skating it down the ice. Defender meeting him. 3 minutes left to go in the third. Illinois getting it back now. Center pass to Kolas. Kolas trying to open it up. Sabo passing it towards the front of the net. No one can get a deflection or a clean shot off.
The Illini look a step ahead of the Eagles right now, and that's something good to see down the stretch. Hopefully the momentum from Forfar's goal can carry into another one.
They've got all the energy also on the ice right now. Center pass from Nolan, grabbed by Lenzi. Shot from Lenzi looking for that near post top corner, but it flings hard off the board all the way back to the defensive zone. Ernsting trying to cross ice pass. Good defending from Josh Hart. Dumped there. Hart checking Sulk into the board. Flinged upwards, can't get it, but now it finally pops out. And Rizzo will get it in front of his goaltender, Chris Mallon. 2:10 left. We had overtime here 2 weeks ago in that first game against Central Oklahoma. Illinois won in a shootout after being down 2-0 in the third. They were down 1-0 entering the third here, and a Luke Forfar missed redirect has tied this game up. And we still have a minute 48 left. for someone to potentially get a winner here in regulation.
Keep an eye on Lindsay right here.
Lindsay with an open shot, and he just misses it. Good chance there from Lindsay. It just goes through Malin, but over the net. Lindsay again, who's been very active in this game, helping and replacing the injured Casper Ribba, who scored yesterday. And another shot from Opilka. It's not deflected by Drew Richter. Less than a minute and a half to go. Ken Dottie gets the puck now. Illinois has been controlling this third period. Quinn trying to get it back. He does. Now Stephen Quinn trying to get by Manocchio. Good hit there from Drew Richter. Staying with the Illini now. Stephen Quinn trying to get the puck. Trying to pass it out. Ken Dottie is looking for a pass there. Stephen Quinn still with it. A minute three left now in the final period of regulation. Ken Dottie, simple wrist shot. Deflected by Malin. He kind of hit it off a stick, flew up in the air, but he catches it and stops the clock at 57.6 seconds.
These last few minutes have been exciting. Illini fans that are in the stadium right now are loving it. They're feeling it. The crowd has been electric in this third period. Kudos to them, but this Illini team has really bared down, showed that they're not going to give up, showed that they have all the fight in the world, and hopefully that'll translate into a W that they can grab in this last minute before heading to overtime.
Richter gets it after the Robert Morris faceoff win. Nolan now passed to Richter. Richter trying to get a shot off. It's deflected off of the skate of Cacciotto. Trying to pass it out. Now Nolan. Quinn's got it now. Past the blue line. Forfar and Richter on the ice with him. 41 seconds to go. Quinn gets hit. Now open to Drew Richter near the right circle. Richter shot, wrist shot off. Nolan looking for the open net. Oh, what a save by Malin as he recovers it and saves it. Forfar keeps it onside. Nolan had all the space in the net to try and score, but Chris Malin with a clutch save with 30 seconds left. 22 left now to go. Kolas keeps it onside. Can Illinois maybe steal it here at home? Opilka dumping it off. 14 seconds left. Trying to get by Cacciotto. And the clock stops at 12.2.
That Quinn Richter Forfar line was the right one to have on the ice. Almost delivered there. But with 12 seconds to go, we'll see who the Illini roll out for a potential chance to steal a victory
also,
in the last 12
goodness,
seconds.
Goodness, that save by Chris Malin.
Phenomenal save. We've been saying that all game, both Malin and Barnhart will be in discussion for the number one star. I think it only depends on who wins this game.
Just 12.2 to go. Ernsting wins the faceoff. Illinois is going to have to go quick up ice, but Joe Nolan whiffs a clearance. But he's able to recover and stop Robert Morris from potentially getting a shot at the last second. 2-1, and we will have overtime at the Big Pond. Luke Forfar with a third period power play goal. And once again, Illinois is going to overtime at home, this time against Robert Morris.
And I know how much the dads like overtime. I know my dad back home is a huge fan. Whenever a game goes into overtime, there's nothing like sudden death hockey, and you'll see some in about 2 minutes.
There's nothing like 3-on-3 hockey. I mean, with the space on this ice, we know why it's called the Big Pond. It's only mentioned every time we're on air. 3-on-3 hockey with this much space on the ice just spells exciting 5 minutes. Just what some of the best you can get in sports, honestly, is 3-on-3 hockey in overtime.
Yeah, and especially in an environment like this where the whole crowd is into it, it's going to be a lot of fun. This overtime period is huge for the Illini, too, because if they come away with a sweep of the number 12 team in the country, they're going to move up from 10, maybe not quite to 4 like they were last week, but this swing is huge.
Set the tone here if you're just joining us. Joe Molfetta scored the opening goal late in the second period for the Robert Morris Eagles. Third period, Illinois had all the chances. Their second power play of the game. 29 seconds in. Opilka wrist shot from the blue line, deflected in by Luke Forfar for his fifth goal of the season. And now we are into overtime. Illinois trying to stay undefeated at home. Robert Morris trying to hand Illinois their first home loss this season. We're going to have 3-on-3. And through 60 minutes of hockey, I am sure Nick Fabrini is very happy with the fact that Illinois did not get a single penalty all of regulation.
Yeah, they played a very disciplined 60 minutes. And I think that's the reason why 53 minutes in, they were able to tie the game. I mean, it was a huge goal by Luke Forfar, and it was just a testament to this Illini team staying disciplined, staying fighting, and this time they were able to come across with a a goal that'll send this game into overtime.
It's 3-on-3 time. Ernstin, Kolaz, and Opilka. Their numbers are in the 20s, but they're going to try and get win number 8 here. Nitschi on the ice with Molfetta and Holt in the first 3-on-3 of this overtime. 5 minutes to go. Goal wins it. No one scores. We've got a shootout, which would be the second this season at the Big Pond. Ernstin skating past the blue line, trying to get by Holt. He does, but unable to get a clear shot. Now it's a good check by Nitschi trying to get it now to Holt. Kolaz fell down deep. He's trying to recover now as it's a 3-on-2 now for Robert Morris. Holt skating into the middle. Pass to Nitschke. Center pass to Holt. Holt in the high slot there. Just settling it down here 40 seconds into overtime.
One of the things, too, it's got to be tough to make changes when it's 3-on-3 because it's a recipe for an odd man rush.
So they're slowing it down. Nitschke creates some space for himself. Quick slap shot there. Oh, good save by Jake Barnhart.
What a glove there by Barnhart. Keeps the Illini in this game once again.
4:06 on the clock, and we've got our first change. Forfar, Lenzi, and Nolan on the ice for Illinois. It's Martin Stover and Josh Hart on the ice for the Eagles. Eagles face-off win. They've had the puck in the offensive zone for a majority of this first minute of overtime. Martin. Pass to Stover. Lenzi trying to win it and trying to get a breakaway here. We could have a decent amount of those in this period. Now almost trying to get one there, but Robert Morris has done a good job keeping the puck in the offensive zone. And with them, Martin slap shot off. I think Hart saved it himself. Hart now in front of the net, chance open, and he scores! Robert Morris winning overtime. Goal from Ryan Martin. 1.5 minutes into overtime, and the Eagles have handed Illinois their first home loss of the season. Wow. The air just sucked out of the building.
What a game. I think the reason the Illini weren't able to secure that puck is they had an opportunity for Forfar to go on a breakaway, like you were about to say, but they did not put enough sauce on that pass. They ended up having a giveaway, a 3-on-2. Barnhart was left and right making a save, unable to stop the final shot there. Still a great effort by Barnhart, a testament to this team, the Illini, great fighting effort that might not have come out on top, but nothing to be ashamed of tonight.
And you mentioned Ryan Martin at the beginning of the broadcast, the most points between any player on the ice tonight, his 7th goal this season, giving him 16 points on the year. And he comes up with the overtime winner. So Robert Morris now 5-7, all 5 of their wins on the road. Illinois is now 7-4-2, and that is a tough loss to swallow for them. It's their first at home this season, and it comes in overtime.
Yeah, it sure is a tough one to swallow. It was a great game fought by both teams, great goaltending, great defense on both sides. Robert Morris just had a couple better chances throughout this whole game, and they ended up having one more goal.
So let's talk about our 3 stars now as Nick Fabrini and his players are going to be meeting in the center of the ice. We said that whoever wins this game, the goalie is going to get the first star. So I think we can agree that Chris Mallon is our first star.
Yeah, he's the number one star for sure. He made saves all night long. They might not have been as acrobatic as Barnhart, but he played one heck of a game in between the pipes. And that's the reason that Robert Morris comes out on top tonight.
Yeah, and I think the save that we have to point out as the key save of the game, Joe Nolan had about 70% of the net open from the blue line on the left side of the net, and Mallon just kind of was all the way on the other post, and he just skates as fast as he can all the way and makes a massive save, what would have probably been an Illinois winner late in that third period.
Not only did he smother the puck there, but he also didn't let up another rebound, which would have been another shot for the Illini. There were, 30, 40 seconds left in the game at that point?
Yeah.
Great awareness there to hold the puck and not give the Illini another chance.
I think second star I'm going to give to Jake Barnhart. I think both goalies deserve to be in there.
Yeah, I agree. Barnhart's the number 2 star for me. He played a phenomenal game behind the net. Might not finish the way he liked to, but nothing to be ashamed of for him. And for me, that third star of the game goes to the guy who netted the one that we're going to remember, the goal at the end of the game there, Ryan Martin, his 7th of the year to go with 9 assists, put the game away for the Robert Morris Eagles. just he's a good player. That was a great goal.
And a great game indeed. I mean, we had all the back and forth the first period once again. Oh, sorry for the voice there, losing it a little bit. First period there was a little slow, but then second and third picking it up a little bit. Still an anomaly to see a hockey team go an entire game, basically 61, 62 minutes without a penalty. There were only two power plays all game and one 10-minute misconduct penalty, just something we're not used to seeing here as we are probably going to send it off right now as the Ice Arena empties out here at the Big Pond as the Robert Morris Eagles win 2-1 in overtime here, the first home loss of the season for Illinois. They will return here next weekend. They want Bama, and they got Bama, and it's going to be on a sheet of ice Friday and Saturday. So for Claire O'Brien and Anthony Pasquale, I am Ori Benatar. Thank you for joining us once again. We hope you enjoyed the audio stream along with the video stream. Two YouTube streams at the same time. Could happen again. We'll see. We're hoping it doesn't. We'll hopefully have video with the audio next time. And until next time, we'll see you guys. Enjoy the weekend.
Like bumblebees, they travel like a burning flame.